of my life. All right.
You got it.
Really.
You're creepy.
There's something disturbing about you.
I'm telling you.
You need to see a psychiatrist.
I respect you so much that that's what I will do for you.
Thank you.
That would be
my kind
gesture.
Please see a doctor.
Howard, I gotta ask you a question. And you got to be really honest with me. Really honest with me.
Go ahead.
You've thrown parties at your apartment. You had a New Year's Eve party. Okay, so say it's New Year's Eve next week.
Right.
And you're having this party. You really are. You're inviting Artie and me and, you know, and Robin. And even you want to invite Richard, you know, because you're going to invite the whole group that works with us. Now you got to make that decision. I'm being very serious. If it were today, would you invite Sal?
I would invite Benji before I'd invite Sal.
Wow.
I mean, Sal, never letting him near me.
No, I'm serious.
Right. I'm being serious.
You mentioned guns and knives. Better get Ronnie.
No, I mean, seriously, Sal's got a fixation. And no, I wouldn't invite him to my place. Ever. Ever.
You want to look over there now.
I mean, Richard, I'd invite.
Thank you.
Good. Invite him.
Even Scott the engineer could
go. Studio.
I'd invite Scott any time. I have invited Scott over to my place.
Good. But no Sal.
I mean, after this, no.
I don't
it's
blame
creepy.
You.
You are treating me the same way your father treated you. So I hope you're... I want to let
you don't know anything about my father's treatment.
Constantly with
me.
The father and son.
Yes. Why is he your father?
I am not your father. You're not healthy. After you see a psychiatrist and you get a clean bill of health, then we'll talk.
It's not He's got nice. Mental issues, Sal. You got mental issues, Sal.
Sal, you don't know it yet, but you're mentally ill.
It's not nice to say you would invite Scott over me. It's not nice to say.
But it's true. Gary asked me... It's not nice to say you want to be in my bed with me and cook for me and come over and
shock you into reality.
Sal, are you going to do, and so based on all of this, are you going to go see anybody or do you just sort of say, hey, those guys are nuts, there's nothing wrong with me?
Howard made it clear, stay away from me.
No, but are you going to go see somebody?
No, who's there to see? I like the guy. I mean, I admire him and I thanked him.
You don't think there's anything wrong? You don't think maybe...
Oh, my God.
No, I'm just serious.
If I asked to sleep over your house, you said yesterday it would be fine. There's nothing wrong. But I asked Howard Stern... It's
Sal, you're stepping over the line, Sal.
You're missing the whole point. You still don't see it.
I see it.
No, you don't.
All right. You want me to see a therapist? I'll see a therapist.
No, I want you to want to see a therapist.
I don't think I need to.
Then don't.
Then it ain't gonna work. Stay away from me.
All right.
And that's not mean to say. It's just
I know.
I'm giving you tough love, son.
Don't step over the line, Sal.
Now we're talking.
Yeah.
Don't start.
Right, listen to Bobo, man. Don't step over the line.
And believe me.
What line? Your hairline?
Yeah, my hairline.
Thank you, Bobo.
All right, man. Love you.
Whenever Bobo tries to get in with a gang, somebody just cracks a hair joke at levels.
And it's over.
That's it. It's over. Hey, who's crazier, Sal or Bobo thinking that looks like real hair?
here comes the guy who's going to help and bail me out.
Doug Goodstein.
Yeah. The Stern Show weasel. Here he comes.
Not today, Sal. Sorry. Just one real important question. Have you told your wife about this, and what does she think?
My wife's away right now. That's why I want to stay by Howard's place.
But did you...
That's where you need to be, away.
Lucky me.
And seriously, Sal...
Sal, you're amazing.
I'm not going to goof on you, because this is so beyond funny at this point. It's frightening everyone. I'm being dead serious with you.
All right, what are you thinking, Doug?
No, I want to know if his wife knows. But also, like Gary was just saying, like, at any point in your head, did you say to yourself, this is crazy?
Yes.
I'm crazy.
Yes, I panicked. I panicked yesterday morning. I almost had a panic attack.
After we discussed this with you or before?
Before. When I walked in that morning, because you didn't reply to my email, so I'm like, oh, man.
Howard, I got to tell you.
I have no place to stay.
I didn't see this email till after we spoke yesterday, but I guess at some time during the night, he sent me an email. I haven't heard back from Howard. What the hell's going on? I'm waiting to pack my bags. It was crazy.
Oh, my God. Can you imagine what was going on in his head?
Well, he said to me yesterday, I don't believe that Gary ever sent him my email.
Because he's keeping him from me.
Yeah.
Dude, you're looking at me like a lover.
No, I am not.
Look at me. You're looking at me like a lover. No. I'm almost like a god. I'm the secret to your happiness.
Yeah, you're your secret to happiness, but not a lover, man.
All right.
No you're way. The girl who holds
just
the keys.
It's a good guy that has brought me happiness.
Sal, what percentage of your day, honestly, do you just sit there and think about Howard? And scenarios that...
Be honest.
Like, okay. Be honest.
My day is consumed with thinking about the show, which in turn would make Howard happy.
You're lying because you've already said to us a number of times. Hold it. You've said to us a number of times, I pictured that we would do this. I pictured that we would do that. I picture. Right. You have whole scenarios in your brain of what you and Howard have already done together.
Okay, that's an extension of the show because if we, I'll tell you why. What I do is I sit down, I thought, okay, if Howard says yes, how can I make this an entertaining night? So I thought of a few scenarios. I'm just telling you.
All right, be honest, yes.
Yeah, I'm being honest. I thought of things that could be interesting, like you would do if you had a party or something, Robin. And that's what I did. But my days...
I've never sat and thought, you know, Howard and I are so comfortable together, we can sit on the couch and not say anything.
Well, I'm saying that now. I go, that's the type of...
But how do you know that I would be comfortable sitting on the couch not saying anything?
See, I don't. And that's the
That's where you're getting a little
That's what kooky. I have to realize, right.
Yeah. And I'm not like that.
Right, I have to
I don't like sitting on a couch with you not saying anything. Unless you have handcuffs.
You're feeling constantly like you need something to say.
Yeah.
And another
Here's Sal's day. 4:30, wake up. 4:31, start to stalk Howard and think about him.
No, but my day is consumed with the show. I haven't even written any stand-up in 6 months because every thought that I have that could relate to the show, I put into the show.
That's good.
Do you sometimes, though, then visualize what Howard's going to think of what you've written?
Yes.
When I finalize it, as Howard being the guy who it is the Howard Stern show, I try to write and create within the vein of what Howard would find interesting.
But then you play it for him, you do it in your head, and you have him reacting.
Sometimes I see a scenario of Howard liking it, but any artist would or wouldn't.
No, when you create material, yes. I don't think it's the same.
I had to get the email because I just wanted to quote it. It came at 11:40 the night before last. Mm-hmm. Where's Howard's reply? 6 question marks in a row. I need to pack my bags, man. Now I'm screwed. It's 12 a.m. and I have no response.
Holy mackerel.
It was late and he didn't respond. That's all. So that.
Meanwhile, Gary sends me Sal's email about Sal wants... We just think Sal wants to sleep over my apartment. I write back to Gary, what the F is this?
Right.
With a question mark, I go, what bit is this? So then Gary goes, look, I had to call you. Now I'm sick as a dog.
Uh-huh.
He says, I had to call you. I go, oh, I said, why is this Sal doing a bit?
And
Gary goes, I got to tell you something. I don't think Sal's doing a bit. This is Sal. I go, you're kidding me. He's for real?
And Howard goes, Gary, you're being pranked. And then I'm feeling like a rube, but I don't know.
I think you called this one right, Gary.
You were right, Gary.
Yeah.
Sal called me about 10 minutes or so after he sent the email. And for 5 minutes, I was on the phone with him saying, dude, just stop. You're kidding with me. This is a joke.
Right.
I was just like, please tell me this is a joke. Even right now, I'm saying, just tell us this is a joke.
We're all a joke. But Howard, do you realize how many people he spoke to? Lewis, he spoke to me, he spoke to Doug, he spoke to a lot of people. We all told him it was a bad idea.
I spoke to Lewis before this. Last week, I had lunch with Lewis on
Did he tell you that this was a good idea?
What did you speak to Lewis about? How to what?
Just how to get, you know...
Closer to you.
Yeah, without it sounding gay, how to win over your friendship over and above the profession.
How would Lewis
know? Can you imagine having a lunch about that?
Lewis just gave me some suggestions.
What was Lewis's suggestion?
He says, look, Howard is so... Howard is such a great...
you see, when you hang out with...
Lewis, that must have been the weirdest lunch of your life.
I said you need to get over whatever feelings you're having inside you. I said that everything that you're feeling inside has nothing to do with Howard and has everything to do with your insecurity.
Right.
And I said that if it's that important for you to have just lunch with Howard, then maybe someday you could just say, hey, you want to get a bite to eat? I don't think it would be a big deal. I never said you should ask him for a sleepover party.
I thought it was weird when I take Sal and Richard to dinner to say, hey, you guys are doing a good job. His hands are shaking and everything. I didn't realize he's all nervous.
Yeah, this is like his first date.
That's a good point. Mm-hmm. Why the sleepover? Like, why not, if you want to be Howard Stern, why not dinner? Dinner is feasible.
Only because...
Wife was out of town. Like, his wife was out of town, like, this was his moment. You know what I mean?
See, if my wife was out of town, I'd be thinking about how to get over a chick's apartment.
Go to Scores.
Something.
I can't go to Scores. My wife, you know.
Can I talk to them about the phone call you got Wednesday night? Why you had to go home Wednesday night?
Yeah, you could tell him.
Me and Sal were out at a comedy club, and he got a phone call from his wife in California. He was going to stay at my place Wednesday night, but he had to go home and take the trash out.
She called from California? Yeah. Take the trash out?
I called her. I said, listen, I'm going to stay over Christie's house. She goes, you have to take the garbage out. The house is going to stink, and you have to bring the mail in. I go, well, it's
and
real.
And you did
late.
It?
I went home.
Yeah, yeah, you're pussy whip.
God.
No, I did the right thing. Yeah. I mean, you know.
You make fun of me some more.
Wow. This ain't nice.
Lewis, what a lunch. That's the best. I went to lunch with Lewis to find out how I can get closer to Howard.
Can you imagine this lunch? You get together with a guy and all he can do is talk about how he can be closer to you.
Yeah. You should have alerted the authorities.
I thought it was a fairly pleasant conversation. I mean, I think Sal has his own insecurities, just as everyone else that works for the show does, but... I mean, I walk in this morning and Sal says, hey, good morning, Benedict Arnold.
Yeah.
Right, right, right. Do you guys go to lunch often, or was that the first time?
No, we've only gone to lunch a couple times.
Didn't you think...
I like that he's turning to Lewis for some tips.
Right.
I
mean, Lewis, you hardly know.
I've talked to Lewis four times.
Lewis, let me tell you, Lewis is the voice of reason, because everybody in this place, like Lewis says, has an insecurity and has their own agenda. Everybody here, Howard, wants to please you, believe me. Gary, you
are the biggest ass kisser out of everybody. Gary, you come in here doing backwards, sparking out of your teeth. Sal, I'm not. We work together.
I hire, you know, I'm the guy who approves of Gary being the producer in this.
That's my point. Right.
Okay.
We're all here to please.
That's called work.
No, we're all here to work to make the show better.
Right.
Nobody else thinks of it as just pleasing Howard. Right. We're doing our jobs.
We're all doing what we can to be good at our jobs.
Right. And to me, to be good at my job is to do something great for the show.
No one's trying to outdo you in terms of, you know, getting in your way near me.
I understand.
Gary's not kissing my ass so he can be closest
to me.
Right.
You know, what do you want? You're saying, like, Gary needs to move over so you can have a little piece of ass.
Yeah. And you know what?
What are you saying?
When I give Howard something good that works for the show, I'm like, damn, I'm satisfied that I've somehow made the show better. I don't sit there and go, I've pleased Howard. I just don't.
I'm satisfied that I made the show better because the show relates to Howard being satisfied.
All right, listen to me. Listen to me.
Let's end this lunacy.
You don't get it.
Gary doesn't get it.
I don't think he ever will.
I'm not sure you get it.
I get it. I completely get
it. Time for another lunch with Lewis.
Yeah, Lewis, this is your pet project.
Hey, Lewis, I blame you for this.
I'm like the Dr. Phil of K-Rock all of a sudden.
You should have taken a fork and stuck it in his head.
Who knew? I didn't know Lewis was the one you go to when you have a problem. I'm going to be calling you.
No, Lewis is the one you go to when you want to get close to me.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Yes. I didn't know I was supposed to be doing that.
Lewis has a specific skill.
Lewis, how would I get closer to Robin?
This is a riot.
Hey, Pop, you're on the air.
Yeah, this is Sal. Yo, Sal, you're connected. You was in the street, now you're connected. So, you know, don't mess it up, because you're messing it up. Now people are going to see you before they say, yo, it's Sal. Now they're going to see you. Yo, let's get the hell out of here.
Dominic, you're on the air.
There's a psychiatric term for what he has.
Yeah, I'm sure you have it, too.
Whack job.
Okay, ready?
Yours is called fat pig-initis.
It's called... Obsessive ideation. What it is the following, and I'm reading from a book called DSM-5. It's how we define the psychiatric illness he has. He's obsessed with the thought or personality of a person. He himself has thoughts that are not connected. He fantasizes about a relationship, whether it be emotional or sexual. When not pleased and can't reach this goal, can often become violent.
When were you diagnosed with that?
Yeah, see.
Yeah, but there's no violence and there's nothing sexual.
No, not yet. No. Well,
yeah, but you have an emotional.
So far, you've been able to make headway. Now that you can't get to this next level, I'm fine.
But you hear what Dominic said?
Yeah.
Sexual or emotional?
Right. It's the emotional part. I want people to know it's emotional.
Well, because you think this will solve your unhappiness.
Right. He's already said that. Howard makes him happy and he needs to be closer.
And when it doesn't reach it,
That's what I'm saying. Like, it can get to a point where he decides, you know what, maybe I need to take some other action.
I have to get his attention.
Spray painting the King Cullen.
Dominic.
Howard just said it.
Dominic, what do I do?
Well, first of all, you just said it, and that is that with other actions, because I must have him notice me. Now,
you know
can I ask a question?
Sure.
Did you have any relationship with your dad?
Very awkward one. Very cold.
But he's very comfortable with Howard when they just sit and watch TV together. They don't even
have
to
speak. I'm the dad. I'm the good dad.
When you say cold, he wouldn't react to you at all?
No, not really. He would just put me in. My dad was Sicilian, so that was it. What he said is how it went.
And no questions asked.
Boo-hoo.
Howard is a more understanding man.
Therapy sessions all the time.
Yeah, I don't think Howard's an understanding man. I think, Howard has no obligation to understand what I need.
It's actually, Howard is just like his dad. He's still trying to get his attention.
Right.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
You know, Sal,
if you were my son, I'd put you in a pizzeria.
even before Sal was working here, getting your approval was really, really, really important to him, because he used to send in song parodies and stuff, and if he didn't get a response in like a day, he would just start instant messaging me or calling me and saying, what'd you hear, what'd you know?
All right, listen, this is all getting too creepy. I choose to ignore it.
You know, he's got a good act, though, because I never knew he was this crazy.
Yeah, he's pretty crazy.
Yeah, I'm fine.
For you, you're fine.
I keep bringing in one crazy person after another.
I know. What is it?
I don't know, man.
Alex,
surrounded by kooks.
Sal, do you have any fantasies about how happy you could be? Or
well, we went through that already, Dominic. Yeah. If you heard earlier, he went through them all. And
oh, my God. Are they scary?
Well, they're the answer to all of his problems.
It's like this, Dominic. Imagine a steak being taken away from you.
Nah.
There you go. Is that scary enough?
All right, Dominic, thank you. Bye. I think Dominic suffers from the same thing. But
oh, absolutely. That's why he recognized the syndrome so quickly.
Yeah, but he won. He gets in.
Oh, boy.
Oh, never mind.
All right.
He won.
I'm in the clear. I apologize for creeping.
I'm in the clear. No,
Howard,
you're not.
No, I would leave the mic open and just get out of here.
Dominic won. I didn't. Well, be mad at Dominic, not
me.
Yeah,
take it out on him.
That's right.
It'll make you happier. I know it will.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Don't ever go there again.
Dude.
Never go to Scores again.
No problem.
Okay. Sad that you don't understand what I'm saying. He takes everything as a challenge. By the way, East Side and West Side. East Side and West Side.
Oh, he's not supposed to go to either one?
I don't want to.
I don't care.
I don't want to hear about East Side or West Side.
You know what? I really don't care. You know,
you really don't understand what I'm saying.
You think you're hanging this over my head.
No. You know that I'm right.
You think you're hanging this over my head about going to Scores. Okay, fine. I won't go to Scores.
You said
no
that.
No problem.
I never said don't go
West
to Scores.
West Side, Fort Lauderdale, Baltimore, wherever. Chicago.
I never said don't go to Scores. You did. All I said to you is...
No,
I
you said it yesterday.
No, you said it.
No, you did.
It never occurred to me to say don't go to Scores.
No, play the tape back.
Play it and find it. You play it.
Back.
Go get it. Go get it from
I
Gary and play
it. I don't have
Gary
it.
Gary will give it to you, I
don't
promise.
Have it.
Go listen to it.
And then there's all the crap with that Sal guy out there that he's all upset that I'm not talking to him. I have a good reason not to talk to him.
Why are you not talking to Sal?
Because Sal's an idiot.
Well, that's a good reason.
Yeah, he's an idiot because I'll take...
Why is he an idiot?
Because I invite him to a party that I wasn't supposed to have, obviously, and that he has to come, and the only reason he could come was because he told his wife he was going to work there, that he had to tape people.
Right. That's true. I told him to tape people.
He didn't get one lap dance. He didn't go near one girl because he's afraid that his wife will beat him up.
You know, Ron, you're such an idiot and an a-hole, and you are completely delusional. Otherwise, you would understand Howard. Number one, you take advantage of him completely.
Yeah,
number two,
I've been taking advantage of him all these years.
I don't say that. I just made
Sal,
one
Sal, don't
point.
Fight Howard's back.
I don't feel Ronnie takes advantage.
I got the point yesterday. Don't worry.
Right. I don't feel Ronnie takes advantage of me all the time. I think this time he didn't think it through. I think it would have been a nice thing. He has a relationship with Lonnie because of me.
I didn't.
The guy will do anything for you, Lonnie.
Yeah, okay. So you say
I'll have three of my friends over with me for a night at Scores. 40 people already. That's getting into the Howard Stern crew going over. I don't even bring 40
just
of my
because
crew.
You know a guy will say yes doesn't mean you should ask for it.
Right.
Ronnie consented to my recordings before and during
of
the
course.
Party. And now he's mad at you, but he's taking it out on me because I'm an easy target.
Right.
I did the right thing for the show where you took advantage
what
of the show.
You did the right thing for the show. That wasn't a show.
You know what?
Wasn't a show.
You know, the only reason why you're popular right now is because of me recording this to begin with so you could take advantage of another party. I'm contributing to your airtime, you idiot.
Sal.
You're a total jerk.
He's taking it out on me.
I don't know what's going on with you.
Even Stuttering John never came to a party with a tape recorder. Okay?
All I know is...
He went there and had a good time.
That's between the two of you.
But you told Sal to take the tape recorder.
Of course I did.
So why is he yelling at Sal?
Because he wanted to record the drunken...
But why is Ronnie yelling at Sal? Sal was doing what you told him to do.
It makes no sense to me.
Because he's taking it out on me. He doesn't want to take it out on you.
Yeah. No, I'm not taking it out on him, no. Exactly.
Ronnie was the first jackass to jump up and get on the recorder that night. Happy as a pig in manure.
Right.
And now it's an issue after you yell at him. Now it's my fault.
Right. Exactly.
Now, listen to me. I'm calmly telling you this.
I think we have a bunch of lunatics right
now. We do. That's clear. And I feel bad because Ron, I don't think Ronnie really understands what I'm saying.
No.
He thinks I'm attacking him personally. I'm not.
Yeah.
I'm telling him you made a bad choice.
Mm-hmm. I heard you.
You don't take advantage of Lonnie. You took advantage.
I never take
advantage. And I think you know deep in your heart, you know you did.
Right.
And let's face it, you know what? When did you ever have a 40-person party at Scores before we started working here?
Every year.
Oh, before you started working?
No.
Okay. So why does it
happen? Why is it this year that you said something and all the other years you never said anything?
Because it's too much.
Because you weren't there.
40 people is too much.
So you're mad because you weren't there because I didn't schedule it on the day that you come.
No.
Yeah.
You shouldn't be throwing parties.
Right. Okay, I'm not. Don't worry about it. I told you. It's done.
Hey, Ronnie, did you throw Lonnie a couple of bucks after the party?
Did I throw Lonnie a couple of bucks?
Yeah, did you take care of Scores in any way, shape, or form?
Yeah, that's none of your business.
How much did you give him?
That's none of your
business. Yeah, because you're lying. You gave them zero, you liar.
Oh, really? That's
zero.
None of your business. That's none of your goddamn business.
Believe me, I got plenty of your business on tape. You should be real nice to me.
Yeah, good.
Oh, man. Getting vicious. Oh, wow.
Zero?
Yeah.
He gave zero to Lonnie?
Yeah, did he throw him a couple
How
of bucks?
How do you know what I did?
What did you give him?
I ain't telling you. I don't
care. You ain't telling me because there's nothing to tell.
You're
you gave him nothing.
Under my shoe. You're nobody to me.
I'm really hurt. I'm really going to lose sleep tonight over that one.
Yeah, you're going to lose a lot of sleep tonight when you get home. Spitting on girls. That's how you get off? Yeah, you're a psycho also. You talk about me.
Little midget chauffeur driver with J-Lo sunglasses on. Jesus Christ, look at you.
Those are J-Lo sunglasses?
Yeah, it's like when Jennifer Lopez wears them in Star Magazine. Yeah, those are the same glasses.
Yeah, and what do you wear? What's that? $10 glasses that you bought in the drugstore?
$8. Watch yourself. I got it at Genovese, okay? You know, actually, I said I worked for the Howard Stern Show. Could I get
you
these glasses on the house?
Stern Show. You're on trial here.
So what you're saying is you go to stores and say you work for the Howard Stern Show and then you get free glasses?
Yeah, it works like a charm.
I don't think that's right, do you, Ronnie?
I don't care.
You know? You hear what he's saying? He goes to the store.
I don't care.
The glasses store.
I don't care
store.
What he does.
You know, Ronnie.
I don't care. You know what?
I tried
to be nice to him from the first day he walked into here. And then he just stabbed you right in the back, just like John did.
You're real nice.
He's
yesterday,
trying to be just like John.
Yesterday when Howard was looking for
you,
and I politely asked you to come in, how nice were you to me?
How people like you around
you
here.
You take it out on me because you're mad at Howard, admit it.
I'm not mad at Howard.
Yes, you are.
I got Howard's point. I know what I have to do.
Called him a chick the other day behind his back in Scott's office.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
And I cursed him out, too.
When you yelled at Gary
Every time he was on the screen that night, too, I cursed him out, too.
He said, you.
Yeah, right.
And nobody applauded. They looked at Ronnie like he was a pathetic moron.
Right. Okay.
Do you really think the people are there for you? You know what you're like? You're like MC Hammer, who threw those big elaborate parties, and when he ran out of money, he was gone. When Howard leaves you once and for all, nobody's going to come to your party. Nobody cares about
you.
Nobody.
Your wife to beg her to let you come to the party.
I didn't.
You idiot.
My wife, see, that's where you're going beneath the belt. Let's discuss the issue at hand. Nobody cares about you. They're there for food and women.
Good.
Take you out of the equation. They're still there.
You didn't have
they
any
were there
food
for
and you
free
didn't go to women.
Food.
All you do is walk around that stupid
You know what it was? It was like a bar mitzvah with boobs. You had nothing to do with it.
And my point is that I would like to reward my troops with a party like that, but I don't want to take advantage of Lonnie.
Because you're a gentleman, not a scumbag. He's a two-bit Jackie Martlin, the same way Jackie would plug a hotel.
Right, yeah, I'm just like
He's
him.
Doing it with Scores.
I've been doing it all these years, that's right.
At least Jackie didn't take 40 people to the motel and free food and everything else. Should be ashamed of yourself. Get out of here. Get me sick.
Come on. What is going on?
You know, put that, stand in front of that limo and put it in neutral and kill yourself.
Yeah.
Okay. That disco on wheels.
Yeah, I can't wait to be the fly on the wall in your house tonight.
South Bronx with a disco ball and a chair and a steering wheel.
Because somebody might tell my wife that.
Well, it has nothing to do with telling my wife. I have no problem not getting a lap dance. I don't want one.
Yeah, right. That's why you're standing there spitting on girls yesterday.
Man, you're going in the danger zone, dude.
Oh, dude, I'm scared. You're scaring me.
I'm not.
All
right, fine. Whatever. You're talking to the guy who taped the night. Remember that.
Good. I'm real scared. Go ahead. Play whatever you want. According to him, I buried myself already anyway.
I'm not saying you buried yourself.
No,
you're
I'm talking according to him.
What's wrong with a married man not getting a lap dance?
You're gay.
I agree with Ronnie on that.
He goes to a strip club and sits there with a tape recorder.
Me?
Howard Stern Show. Oh, can you come here and record this for me?
At least I'm contributing in a positive way, not taking advantage
of
the boss.
It wasn't work, dummy.
It was work for me.
Yeah, well, that's the only way you're allowed to go.
Apparently you don't know how to
work. That was the only way you're allowed to go. Why don't you admit it?
No,
it had nothing to do with it. Yeah.
Doug Goodstein, you're on the air.
Hey, I don't know if you want me to take away from the fun of berating Ronnie like this.
I'm not berating Ronnie. I'm telling you my point of view.
I mean, I could sort of defend him from last... I wasn't at most of the party this year, but last year I know for a fact I saw him pay thousands of dollars for the party. So I know he pays for it. I know he pays something. I don't know what he paid this year. And
let's put it this way. I don't pay what the party is worth, but I do pay, okay?
And it was generous.
It's none of his goddamn business, because he's not my mother and he's not my father.
Sal, you don't believe that?
I don't believe for a minute.
Yeah, good. Who cares?
Get Lonnie on the phone and ask him.
Yeah, get Lonnie on the phone and ask him.
But then again, Lonnie will back you up because you're always plugging the place. That's your
not
whole
true.
Gig.
No, I know.
Yeah,
I know.
My whole gig. That's right. That's my whole gig.
Howard goes there because he enjoys it sincerely. You go there to throw parties for your friends because you're
exactly.
not
exactly. I'm there every week throwing parties to my friends.
That's it.
Every week.
All right. Well, yes, Dominic Barber, you're on the air.
No, I have to tell you, Sal is way over the line. I saw what happens at Score stays at Score. I don't know. It's worse than Stuttering John. How is he attacking Ronnie? Ronnie's been with you 20 years.
Fatso, how am I over the line? I said, I'm not doing anything over the line.
Fatso, listen.
Listen, everything I've contributed. Listen to me.
You should have been indicted.
Listen to me.
You should have been indicted.
What the hell are you talking about? I'm talking about an issue here, Dominic. Hey, Ronnie is pissed off at me for taping the show. I did everything right. I stayed within the comedic content of the show. That has nothing to do with me.
Listen to you.
And he's the one going Dominic,
Ronnie.
The comedic
Dominic,
Ronnie.
He's going beneath the belt, bringing my wife into this. Where
I'm not bringing
it's
your
irrelevant.
Wife.
Yes,
you told me the only reason you're not getting a lap dance is you're afraid to go home afterwards.
It has nothing to
That's
do with
all
it.
I'm
it's because I'm a married
I'm
man and I'm I have no
it.
Problem with my wife. But you,
you have a lot of problems.
The issue
your wife,
is you
okay?
taking advantage of
Obviously.
Howard, and you're not paying off the club. You're not doing the right thing.
Your wife, because you wouldn't have to go there with a tape recorder. You'd be able to go and hang out like a regular guy.
The only Jew in New York who drives a limo and he's bitter because of it.
Don't become an accountant. What do you hate the Jews into it for? What do you hate the Jews too? Well,
apparently you do, Mr.
And
Italian.
Boy, you hate the Jews?
You're ashamed of Europe around like a
what
Tuba pizza man.
What do you bring the Jews into it for?
The Jews have nothing to do with it. You're ashamed of
the Jews. The Jews,
the Jews hate you. They're probably glad you're a limo driver.
Hate me.
You'd make a horrible accountant. You'd probably soak your clients.
All right. Okay. All right. Dominic, what is your point?
My point is that
real piece of crap.
Whatever you have with Ronnie is your thing. And you have a right to have it. That's your right. But Sal's a new boy on the block, and he's way
Oh, you're setting the rules?
No, you set the rules, but I think it's a little out of
thank
hand.
You, Dominic.
I don't even know why they're so upset.
What are you clenching your fist for, Sal? What, are you ready to hit me? Come on.
I hope those,
go ahead.
I hope those staples
Racist.
Snap in Dominic's stomach and rip his colon open.
Yeah. Big shot.
Well, obviously.
I'm not a big shot. I'm just working here.
You're an idiot.
All right, this idiot got some good tape at your party.
Yeah,
thank you.
Yeah. Oh, big deal.
What about right. Sal's
give you an Academy Award for
with
it.
The comedic
you'll get
content
an FME.
Of the show.
Whoopee-doo.
What?
I just walked in to
I'll get an FME.
When Ronnie wraps his fingers around his neck.
Oh, please.
They're small fingers, believe me. They can't get really around it.
I wouldn't waste my time.
Those midget fingers couldn't get around a hot dog.
I wouldn't risk my job here for a moron like that, a racist.
Little white tootsie rolls on his wrist.
You got to bring the Jews into it. Now you see how, you see how you got working for you?
Yeah, look for a new angle, stupid.
Well, I'm sorry to see that this has turned into...
What happened here?
I don't know what's going on between these two.
He's just taking it out on me because
he's
mad at you.
I'm
the new guy.
Whine.
I'm the easy target for Ronnie.
Well, things have gotten way out of hand.
You know what? I actually broke them up in the hallway. Not broke them up, but I just said, Sal, go sit down for a while. Not that I'm blaming you.
I know. I saw the tape of that.
It was just getting weird. I was just like, you guys got to
stop. Because he doesn't stop.
You guys ought to make up right now.
I'm not making up
with him. I said to him,
I don't make up with a Jew hater.
Well, you should have no problem. You're not Jewish, Mr. Italiano.
Right. Yeah, okay.
Also, Ronnie is not the only Jew in Manhattan driving a limo, Sal. That's ridiculous.
Listen, Ronnie.
I'm done, man.
Hey, Howard.
I don't have to hear any more.
Do you know why Ronnie's mad at me? What's your assessment?
I don't know what's going on with you two guys.
I have no problem with him. No,
you got to listen. A lot
Ronnie
of tension going on.
Ronnie is becoming an emotional wreck.
Yeah, you're becoming an emotional wreck. You keep walking out like a woman. Get in here.
Camera now. Get in here. Get in here.
Go sit in the tickle chair.
Get in the tickle chair.
Ronnie, there's nowhere to go.
Security man, hide.
Come here. Get it to the microphone. I'll talk to you.
the only show where security hides.
You're not following. You're not following.
You made your point already. You made your point yesterday. You made a total moron out of me. You're happy now. It's good. It's done.
All
okay?
Right. Okay.
I like to be the better man and apologize, Ronnie. That's it.
Good.
No bit.
Not accepted.
I'm sorry.
Not accepted after that Jew comment, okay?
Wow.
Not
what
accepted.
Jew comment? He didn't say anything wrong.
Yeah, okay.
Ronnie, I'd like to apologize. Leave it at that. If you want to accept it, that's up to you.
No. Not accepted.
Not accepted.
What are you apologizing for exactly?
I don't know. He's just angry at me. Yeah, right. He's just mad. Okay. And I feel uncomfortable walking the hallways with him.
Are you angry at him for more than bringing the tape recorder? That's what I'm trying to figure out.
No.
Okay. Ronnie, did you consent?
Oh, you're angry with him about the tape recorder?
That's what I said.
I told him to bring the tape recorder. Yeah. I wanted some tape.
I didn't know that. Okay? I didn't know that.
And but he's told still me that saying that.
Whatever. Sal said, you want me to bring a tape recorder and get Phelan when he's drunk.
It got way beyond that.
No, it didn't. What did he do?
I don't need those comments.
It didn't get beyond anything.
I don't need his racist comments. I don't like them.
But that's why I tried like to put him out at the very beginning.
I don't have to talk to him. I can sit out there and he's not even there to me.
Nobody's there to you. You do nothing out there.
See, I don't need him. Like I said, he's a piece of crap under my shoe.
But this started out over something you told Sal to do, and he's like so angry at Sal. Sal was told to do it.
No, he's not angry at Sal.
I know that.
He's not angry at Sal.
I know that, Robin.
But that's what he's been yelling at.
He's angry at me because I said I don't think it's appropriate to have 40 people at scores.
Don't worry about it.
But he's yelling. He's taking it all out on Sal, just as Sal said, because he really can't get angry at you.
And plus, your reaction to this is crazy. I mean, it's like...
I'm always the crazy one.
If I say to you, I don't think it's a good idea...
Everything you say is just fine.
No, I'm just telling you my opinion.
Yeah. I don't care anymore. I told you. It's done.
All right. Done.
It's finished.
Finished.
Finito. Wow.
Go out and talk to the camera in the hall.
There he goes again.
Go ahead. Go meet your camera in the hall.
There's a camera.
There's a camera. Go talk to them.
You know, see, Howard, here's a weird thing. Sal came to me and asked me about bringing a tape recorder.
You're out in the hall. You're done.
Did anybody tell me that?
I'm not taking sides. And I said...
Now I know why you didn't come to the party either, probably.
Because he hates you like everybody else.
No, that's not true.
Ronnie,
you think I didn't come to the party because I don't like you? Or you think I didn't come to the party because I don't want to be taped?
Maybe.
No, that's not it at all.
Yeah.
No, seriously. Yeah, wow.
He has a real problem.
Yeah, because I told Sal.
I'm a psychiatrist like you told me.
Joe didn't come to his party, and now he's got something with Joe. Because Joe didn't go to the party. Joe had something to do with his wife.
I mean, I could say, you want to know exactly why I didn't go to the party? I had plans on going to the party. I was out with Howard on Monday night. I didn't get home until about 9 o'clock. My kids were already asleep. Thursday night, I did an appearance for Heineken where I stayed in the city. And I told the guys, I just didn't think it was right. It was my kid's birthday the day before. I just didn't think it was right to leave home on Wednesday night and not come back till Saturday morning.
Yeah, but doesn't mean you don't like the guy.
Not at all. I would have loved him.
Maybe you didn't go because you were comfortable telling your wife. Whatever. Who cares?
And me, of all people, if I said Newsom was going to be there with a tape recorder, I would be the one not to get on tape. So it's not like I was afraid he was going to tape me, because I told him very clearly, don't mess with the guys, don't bring a tape recorder and hide it. This was specifically to ask questions outside of scores, like when guys were drunk, which is sort of funny.
Listen, he was hiding the recorder.
I know what you mean. Listen, I had my kid Friday night. I put my kid to sleep at we got home from dinner and everything, 11 o'clock. I kind of walked out and got the score. I'm not going to leave my kid to go to scores. Can't do it.
I even asked Lonnie, and Lonnie arranged for a separate room. I even asked Lonnie, even though you gave me permission, I said, Lonnie, is it okay if I pull people aside? He goes, absolutely, Sal, whatever you need. And Ronnie was the first guy to get up and record with me.
I think you owe Sal an apology.
After you yelled at him, he stopped talking to me.
I'm just telling you, I think you owe him an apology.
Oh, good.
You should apologize to the man right now.
Right.
Ronnie, you consented to recording yourself.
I think this whole room will freeze first before that happens.
I just don't get it. There's something going on here. There's something.
It's more.
Yeah.
It's something.
You know, he's got something up his sleeve over there.
Just takes it out on me, whatever.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Poor little innocent boy. Taking it out on you.
What did he do to you, Ronnie?
He didn't do anything to me.
Then why are you upset with him?
Anything. I got head problems.
Are you upset that Sal's a real Italian?
Yeah. There you go. Now you hit it on the head. That's right.
What's lasagna made from?
Yes, Wayne.
Hey, you guys are picking on Ronnie. And
we're not picking on anyone. I'm telling you what I think, I observe.
First of all, Wayne, I don't need anybody calling to defend me. Okay?
So beat it.
How do you know he's defending you?
Yeah, you never heard what he said.
Well, whatever.
First of all, I had a good time at the party. But I would think,
it wasn't my party. It was Howard's party. Don't you understand that?
I didn't say that. It's definitely your party.
It was Howard's party.
But it is there because of me.
And I broke a rule, and I'm very sorry about it.
What rule did you break?
Never mind.
What's the rule you broke?
I broke the rules.
What are the rules?
I broke the rules. It's okay.
I don't think you know what you did.
I know what I did. Believe me, I know what I did.
What did you do? I would like to
know. I know what I did.
You're thinking that Howard's attacks...
The main thing is I know what I did and it won't happen again.
Howard's attacks came from somewhere else? What are you saying? Yeah.
Ronnie, next year your birthday could be in your basement.
No, there won't be any more parties. Don't worry.
Well, it could be in your basement. I won't be there, but it could be in your basement.
Right. Yeah, okay. Thank you.
Wayne, when I'm ready to take advantage of Lonnie's generosity, there'll be another party. You know that.
Absolutely. But, Ronnie, we all had a good time.
Well, we know that.
Right. It was fun.
Whether Ronnie was there or not, you would have had a good time.
Yeah, I mean, isn't Scores fun regardless?
Yeah, I mean, please, Wayne.
Scores is always a great time.
Wayne is so friggin' horny.
Anything to... Ron, I'm glad that you had the party.
Hey, Wayne, I'm having a party where you can rub up against my leg.
You know, it's funny. You are right about Wayne. We were down in Scores, Fort Lauderdale for the grand opening.
And he's flying down to Fort Lauderdale.
And we figured Wayne had given like two Audis away by the time the night was done.
Right.
Porsches.
Two Audis and one Porsche.
Exactly.
Girls, I've got Porsches to give away.
That's not bad.
We gave him away a 20 at a time, but they were Audis and Porsches when he was done.
All right, I'll speak to you all later.
All right, wait.
Can't wait.
Can't wait.
I've given IOUs to strippers that say, I owe you one Porsche. They don't mean anything.
All right, I got to take a break. Ronnie, we can't spend the whole show on you.
I
said we can't spend the whole show on you.
I didn't want you to.
You come in here looking for airtime and no one can help you.
I came in here looking for airtime.
That's right.
Yeah, okay.
He set up this whole Scores thing.
He set up this whole Scores thing.
Yeah,
you can become more famous.
Because I wanted airtime.
Well, you want to be famous.
And like buying, buying that enormous limo was a
This is how I pay him back. I keep saying Scores on the air.
All right. Ronnie, thank you. Sal, thank you. Go out and kiss and hug. And go ahead. And we'll be back.
It's Get John's Job, a fierce competition between nine applicants auditioning to fill the position of former Howard Stern staff member, Stuttering John. This week's applicant is Sal the Stockbroker.
I'm Sal the Stockbroker, and I'm here to win Stuttering John's job. Should be pretty easy. That guy was pathetic. Today... I have a game called Pin the Toothbrush on the Buoy. We got a bunch of kids coming in. We're going to blindfold them, just like Pin the Tail on the Donkey, and they're going to have to jab a toothbrush in Gary's mouth. Should be a lot of fun.
You're going to jab a toothbrush in his mouth?
Yeah, of course. With that stench, it's the least thing, you know, that we could do. Give me a break. I saw Gary walk. Did you notice how Gary walks? I couldn't believe it. I saw Gary walking before. He actually swings with his arms behind his back. He walks like this. He's going down the hallway. I'm like, geez, it's like he's a real monkey. I can't, I swear to God, I have no intentions of putting him down and being the one trick pony, but I can't help it. I really can't. It's ridiculous. The guy literally carries himself like a gorilla. So this should be a lot of fun. It's going to be a good week. People are going to get hurt.
Hey, this week for John's job, we have a candidate that I think everyone will be pleased to hear a week of on the radio.
Yeah.
He's been a longtime caller to the show. He loves to bust Gary's balls. Sal the Stockbroker. He's been begging me for the shot. There he is, Sal the Stockbroker.
Always trying.
I didn't know this was him.
No, it's not.
That's Sal.
I decided the way I'm going to play it is I'm giving him my full cooperation this week because when he sucks, I don't want him to cry that I didn't help him.
Sal, so today we've asked you in your attempt to get John's job. By the way, are you working outside of here?
Yeah, yeah.
You already have a job now.
Stockbroker, you know, doing pretty well.
Are you really a stockbroker when you do it from your living room?
I'm not doing it from my living room.
You're doing it out of your house, right?
You're an idiot. And
do you go to an office?
This guy just does. Do your research, Mr. Producer.
Do you go to an office?
Yes, I do.
Where's the office?
My home office. In my living room.
All right. That's
His mouth from the side, it looks like a beak almost, like a rubber beak. It's amazing.
To see it up close.
Look at you with the jumpsuit on.
What the funny thing is,
the weight of your mouth make you sweat all day? Oh, God almighty.
It's a nice jumpsuit, huh?
Yeah. Not nice on him. You could be laid in gold. You still look like dog crap.
I'm not wearing a jumpsuit for the audience, by the way.
Hey, why don't you jump the hell out of here?
I get a pair of pants, and I have an Adidas jacket on because it's freezing back there.
Freezing. Monkeys are naturally warm. What's the matter with you?
All right. So this is going to go on all week.
All week.
There you go.
It's just the beginning, boy. You're going down.
Sal, you're all hopped up. You're excited. You want the job. Of course, the audience will have the final vote. John the Stutterer seemed to be very popular.
Oh, wonderful.
Loved and Dan them. And Dan the Song Parody Man did pretty well.
Loved them. Uh-huh.
Yeah, so, all right. Are you going out of Vegas?
No, I can't. I just had my third baby boy.
You're kidding?
Yeah.
Wow.
Things are a mess at home.
Best time to leave is when things are a mess.
I know. I'm trying, dude. I'm ready to chuck them all out the window. I have no idea.
So you've prepared a bit for us, I understand. That's your first assignment.
Yeah, and I just want to say, in all seriousness, I know it's not a bit. Ronnie generally is a nice guy. There's a pregnant lady who had to come upstairs today, and Ronnie is cursing me out as I'm making arrangements to bring this lady upstairs. Because of my bid, I needed her. She had to escort her children. So I asked Ronnie, he's like, shut the F up. I got it under control. Getting the F. I don't.
Why is he out there fighting with everyone?
I'm just being polite.
Why is Ronnie the limo driver always unprofessional?
You would have to find out from Ronnie. Howard. I don't know what happens to him.
I even
there.
Said she's a pregnant lady, and he just jumps down my throat like I, you know.
What is the what's going on out there, Ron? You got to get it under control. You're not a superstar.
What are you talking about?
You're a, you're a falling star.
Stop with the F word every minute and yelling at people.
I'm not yelling at him. Everyone, I yell at him.
Everyone is telling me you're yelling at people.
Because this is the bit they all got going on now.
No.
Hey, Ron, I see your attitude sometimes. You don't see yourself. You've got to get that under control.
Are you kidding me?
I'm not.
Are you really going to believe this?
Are you yelling now?
Are you going to believe this?
I do believe it.
Ronnie, I asked you to escort up a pregnant lady. You cursed me out. You said, shut the F up. I have it under control.
Is that true or not?
No, it's not.
You're a liar. I can't believe you.
It's not true.
Are you lying?
What did you say, Ronnie?
What did you say? Did you say shut the F up?
I called downstairs and put the lady's name on the list.
You never said shut up to him?
You said shut the F up. I have it under control. Get back in the room. You're treating me like a Jewbag mafioso that you are.
Wait a minute. Sal, what did you say to me before you walked in here?
I said you're going to get it. And you said, go ahead, everybody else does it.
No. What did you say before you walked in?
I said you're going to get it.
You say, you'll have me in there in about 3 minutes.
Yeah. Yoo-hoo. Right. You're going to get it.
Right.
Exactly. This is the point. I asked you to escort up a pregnant lady. You cursed me out.
Yeah, okay.
Like it was some third-rate busboy or something.
And they did say that last week about you.
It's Dan the song parody man said you got on his case.
Listen. You're getting power mad out there.
Dude, it's not true.
Dude, you're a Jew. Do taxes, okay? That's it.
It's not true, okay? You want to believe him over me?
Say, swear on your son's life. Your grandson's life.
If you want to believe him.
Swear on your grandson's life.
If you want to believe him. I'm not swearing on anything.
There you go. I believe you.
Beat it.
I'm not swearing on anything.
Swear on your grandson's life. You're going
to
say, shut the F up.
Were there any witnesses to this?
Yeah, were there any witness to this, Sal? What, are you going to have your friends come in now?
No. How about the fact that I simply asked you and you cursed me out? I've never brought you up in the past 8 years here. I asked you politely to escort a pregnant lady up. You told me to shut the F up and get back in the room. Unbelievable. You're a disgrace. Get out of here!
Did you use the F word? Tell me the truth. Look me in the eye and tell me the truth.
No.
All right.
Howard, he uses it like water all day long. When I walk in, he was behind the receptionist desk BSing with somebody else. F curses spewing left and right. Are you kidding me? You're a disgrace to your heritage. Get out of here. Go do somebody's taxes, you phony Italian. Should be making pizza.
All right, so Sal, what is your bit for today? Ronnie, I hope you have it under control.
Ronnie's pizza taxes, the Italian Jew. Get lost. You're done. You're finished. You want to make me vomit all over Gary's filthy mouth.
All right, Sal, you're on fire today. This is your
back
big
to
week.
The gorilla.
All right.
Back to the diversion.
Boy, I never saw Ronnie so shut down.
I know.
Wow.
Jew Ginzaloon out.
What is that?
It's not even worth it.
I'm the tough guy Jew. We'll do your taxes and mess it all up on you. Ooh.
All right. Sal, what is your bit for today?
You're looking at him right to the right of me.
Gary, you going to do something with Gary?
The bit is it's a game today. It's called Pin the Toothbrush on the Buoy.
All right. What is this?
We have three kids who are going to be blindfolded, and they're going to have to jab a toothbrush into Gary's mouth, just like the typical
Tail
and the Donkey.
Sal, that sounds like a great bit for radio.
It is. It's a wonderful bit.
Well, hey, isn't this exciting? You have three young children here.
Right.
How old are the kids?
Well, that's Tyler. Go ahead,
Tyler, how are you?
Good.
Tyler, how old are you?
5.
You're 5 years old. I'm over here, Tyler. Look at the man waving. That's me over here. See, can you see me? Mm-hmm. Yeah, Tyler, you go to school?
Yeah.
You do.
And where do you live, in New York?
No.
Jersey?
Jersey?
Yes.
I figured you were a Jersey kid. Now, how do you know Sal the stockbroker?
Do you know him?
You know Sal?
No.
Tell him about the money I gave you, kid.
Sal, how'd you find this kid?
Through my friend, my comedian friend, Paul D'Angelo. He's the kid who did the Pesci FCC bit for you guys.
Oh, you did that bit?
Yeah,
oh,
that was great huge. Bit.
Well, you seem like a good kid. Have you ever seen Baba Booey before? Do you know about this game you're going to be playing?
No.
All right, sitting over there is Baba Booey. See the guy with the big teeth and the big full lips?
Uh-huh.
You see that guy?
Uh-huh.
You look a little in shock by the size of his lips and teeth, are you?
Yeah.
A little bit, yeah. It's a little funny looking, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
All right. Your goal is to be blindfolded and to get the toothbrush in Baba Booey's mouth.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. So
he was practicing in the green room, Howard. He was jumping on the couch brushing Gary's picture.
Do you think you'll... I see you have two other contestants here. Do you think you can beat them?
Yeah.
You do? All right. Let me talk to the other two contestants. And, hi, what's your name? Hello?
Haley.
How old is Haley? Haley's very young.
How old are you, Haley?
2.
2 years old. Congratulations. You're a very pretty girl. Do you know how to play the Baba Booey game?
Yes.
You do. Now, how do you know how to play that? Did someone teach it to you?
Yes.
You don't have to whisper the answers for her. We've got all the time in the world.
She seems to be having a fine time here.
My daddy. Casey taught me. Have you ever been on the radio before?
Yes.
Oh.
Really?
What shows have you been on? You're a showbiz kid, aren't you? All right. Well, you're a young kid, and the game is you got to get the toothbrush in Baba Booey's mouth. Now, those lips and teeth on Baba Booey are very big, aren't they?
Uh-huh.
Yes. Do they scare you a little bit?
Mm-hmm.
You know, here's another kid. This is the third contestant. What's your name?
Zoe.
Zoe. Oh, I like that. How old are you, Zoe?
4.
Good. All right. That's good. And did you ever play pin the toothbrush on Baba Booey?
No.
You've never played before? That's good. This will be the first time. All right. So what do we have to do, Sal? What do the kids have to do?
I have the toothbrush here, a brand new one, so you're not offended.
And where should Gary stand? Well, Gary's going to get on his knees. All right.
Sal's sparing no expense, a new toothbrush.
And a blindfold.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh!
What? All right, the kids are being blindfolded, and Baba Booey. Gary, you're on your knees, I see.
Yes, that's what they told me to do.
All right, be careful. Here come the kids.
One,
Sal is spinning the kids.
2, 3, stick the toothbrush in Booey.
Baba Booey. So I can smell your stinky breath.
Oh, no.
Kid asking for a breath from Baba Booey.
Yay!
Yeah, he got
the
it in.
Toothbrush in the Booey.
All right, you guys got it.
Now,
here to go, Tyler.
Tyler, what is that you said to Gary? I couldn't hear all of it.
I said, Baba Booey, smell your breath so I get breathe so I can smell your stinky breath.
So, Sal, is that part of the game? The kids' strategy. All right. Okay. Well, Tyler, you did well. Let's see how the other kids do. Let's hear from our 2-year-old now.
Haley.
Haley, there's the toothbrush to get in Baba Booey's mouth. Put the blindfold on.
Okay.
Haley. All right, Haley, get ready.
Haley.
2, 3. Put the toothbrush in Booey.
Here we go.
What a game this is, the kids. Oh.
What's happening there?
A little bit of trouble.
Yeah!
Yay! All right. Very good. What a game.
I like it. Haley is clearly a radio veteran.
Haley, did you enjoy doing that? It's a good game, right?
You got to talk to us, Haley. Okay.
You know, with his teeth, people in China right now could stick toothbrushes in it.
All right, I want to go to Zoe, who's a little more verbal. She's 4 years old.
Okay, we're putting the blindfold on Zoe now.
Zoe, you're not nervous to go near Baba Booey, are you?
Here's the toothbrush.
Zoe, you okay in there?
Here we go.
She can't talk well. Blindfolded.
Zoe, you know what you need to do. Right?
Can she hear?
Zoe, can you hear me?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Oh, okay. No, everything's coming apart.
Just close your eyes. We'll take a word for it.
Dad can't get the blindfold
nice
on.
Nice and easy. Take
not
your time,
not over those
Dad.
Headphones.
Don't worry. Gary's lips and teeth will be here all day. Here we go. One,
Zoe,
two.
Okay, Zoe, ask Gary to breathe the stinky breath on you. Then you'll be able to find him.
Okay. Here we go.
One,
two, three. Stick the toothbrush in. Booey. Go, Zoe, go.
Tyler, say it for her.
Right there.
She got it. She got it. Well, that was a home run.
Every kid got it.
Every kid got the toothbrush in Baba Booey. Gary, do we have a prize for the kids? I mean, we must have some young person's prize.
Yes.
How humiliating was that?
You know what? It was so stupid. I'm not even humiliated. I'm really not.
Do you think Sal did a good job with that bit? I thought it was original.
A little bit original. I thought it was bad for the radio. It'll probably look better on E.
Right.
And he could have written more jokes for the kids.
Yeah, I could have written jokes for two-year-old kids.
Oh, well, maybe you should have gotten kids a little bit older.
I think you're ODing on bananas.
I think Gary, as a producer, is right. If you're going to be critical about this...
You could have used a couple of six-year-olds.
Tyler was more verbal because he was older.
And he was funny.
And he was funny when he said, hey, breathe on me and get your stinky breath on me.
Howard did.
Yes.
They want to say stuff.
Go ahead, kids.
Baba Booey Stinky Monkey.
Wow.
Okay, are you happy, Gary? There's the production.
That was a good one.
Go ahead, Tyler.
Baba Booey's breath can kill 100 birds.
I wrote that. There you go. There's your production, bitch, Toothy Aloysius.
Much better.
Kids, do you have anything you want to say? I think Zoe.
Kids, you all win Jackie Marling's new CD called What the Hell Was I Thinking?
Zoe is saying something, Sal.
I'm sorry.
Haley helping out.
Yeah, Haley.
This is like how they train the kids in to hate Americans over in the Middle East.
This is like crazy show business parents with the beauty pageant kids.
Let's see how the audience likes Sal's bit, because the audience is really going to decide. They're
true.
The determining vote. Joe, how'd you like Sal's bit?
Yeah, it's a really good game. I think Sal's got some good ideas there.
All right, then. All right, Joey Boots, go ahead.
I think the kids are singing.
He's an idiot. It was horrible for the radio. Horrible.
Terrible.
Zero.
Wait, the kids are singing over there. What is that, Tyler?
Gary stinks.
All right. Well, kids, thank you.
Stinks.
I can give them something, Howard.
Yes.
I have something for them. I can give them each. Each kid can get $250.
$250. What are you going to do with the money, Tyler?
I'm gonna buy a lot of toys.
All right.
And one's gonna be the Snow Command Center for rescue heroes.
Yeah.
Sounds like you, Artie.
Nice. Good for you.
The Snow Command Center.
Well, Tyler, you're a good kid. Kids, you're all good kids. Zoe.
I already have the Land Command Center and the giant Boat Command Center.
So
you
now
can't put it in. You can't put it in a pool. If you put it in a pool, it'll just sing.
All right.
Getting turned on, Casey.
Well, you can float up.
Well, listen.
Oh, my.
No.
Good job, Tyler.
That's Tyler's not a microphone a in Casey's pants.
Stay away from Casey. Tyler, congratulations. You've won $250. And so have the other kid. Because you got the toothbrush in Baba Booey's mouth.
If I put you in a pool, you'll sink.
All right.
I got a laugh from the kid, at least.
Well, Sal, you know, congratulations. Your first day on the air, and you seem to have scored a home run. The audience seems to have liked you.
We'll put the toothbrush on eBay and auction off for somebody suffering from gingivitis or something like that.
All right. There you go. Gary, you should have a really good week with Sal here.
Today's done.
Today's almost over. Only four to go.
All right. Thanks, kids, and we'll be back right after these words.
What do you think of the game?
I give the game, I give it a... maybe a B-, maybe a C+. I thought the idea was funny, but I would have used older kids and had them have funnier lines and be much more insulting.
So what'd you guys think of the Booey game? Did you have fun?
Uh-huh.
Did you like sticking the toothbrush in his mouth?
Uh-huh.
And was
he
it...
He can't open it.
Was his mouth smelly?
Yeah.
Yeah, huh? It was stinky? Uh-huh. Had a stinky... Was his teeth really big?
Yeah.
And they were they scary, the teeth?
Yeah.
They were, huh? Well, it's all over now, kids. You don't have to worry about the teeth and gums anymore, okay? Uncle Sal will take care of the rest. We'll get rid of that once and for all. All right, guys? Okay. You want Uncle Sal to get rid of the teeth and lips of the monkey?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we'll do that. They seem really scared. I have to come to the children's rescue.
Tyler.
What?
Did Gary's teeth smell?
Yeah.
What did it smell like?
It smelled like 100 hogs in mud, and it was stinky enough to kill 1,000 birds.
Wow. That's pretty bad, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Good job in there, kids.
All right, guys. Say bye, Baba Booey. Bye, Baba Booey. Can you say bye-bye, Baba Booey?
Bye-bye, Baba Booey.
Hey, it's Sal the Stockbroker. It's my second day here on Wind Stuttering John's Job. Today we're doing a revelation, and the revelation, of course, is on Gary. And I turned it into a game called What's So Annoying About Gary? And we secretly interviewed everybody from the show, and they all revealed what they find the most annoying about Gary. And we're going to turn it into a game today to see if Gary can figure out who said what about him.
You think Gary's going to be pissed?
Yeah, I think he is, because when I was going around interviewing people, I had to be quiet, and he would just look at me and just nod his head and sigh, you know, so he knows I'm up to no good again, which I think is great.
We do have Sal the Stockbroker. He's going to be coming in later and playing a game.
All right.
Sal's working hard out there.
What's he doing?
He's like, you know, he's like producing his bits, and, you know, he's ordering people around and, you know, making sure everybody's in the right spot, doing stuff right.
Well, isn't he supposed to do a number of things? A song parody, a bit. He's supposed to have some staff gossip.
He's doing good.
Hey, did you know that Sal the Stockbroker is an anteater, meaning he's uncircumcised?
No, I don't care. Here's what it is.
You're fascinated with that.
Yeah, that's something you guys can get into. I wonder how you found that out.
I got other Sal facts.
It's all right. What else?
Okay. He found out he had a brother after the brother was already dead.
Wow. That's freaky. How does that happen?
I don't know.
How old was the brother?
I don't know.
Oh.
And then then I got other stuff because, you know, I was doing like, you know, just trying to get some info from him.
Most of the mail about Sal was bad.
Oh, yeah?
Get this effing clown off the air. Sal's a one-trick pony. His act is stale and it stinks. Pin the tail on Baba Booey was so weak. Come on, Howard. Have some standards. Listening to the Sal segment, there's another one. May work on E, but I tell you what. It was bad. It was boring. We couldn't see what was going on. Note to Sal the genius. Visual gags make great radio, right? Okay. Gary has big teeth. We all know this. Let's move on. You have no other material. Here's another one. Sal sucks. I hope you don't hire his dumb ass. Let Ronnie give him a beating, because he's deserved it for years. And let Gary give him a kick in the ass, too. We did get some Sal is great stuff, but not many.
Very little, huh?
Great job, Sal. You had me in tears today. Also, Sal's the funniest, most creative, and best candidate for John's job. His responses and insight on your show are the most complete, bringing an additional insight to your show's persona. Long live Sal.
See, that was very nice.
Well, I can tell you what he's up to now.
What?
He just came up to me in the last break and said he's been working on some, like, really important stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, Sal, what do you got for the show? And he shows me he's got, like, 10 drawings of Tom on the button, and he's got a whole bunch of signs he wants to, like, douchebag works here. I'm like, Sal, you can't do that.
Right.
He wanted to hang him up over there where Tom was.
Yeah, but then the problem is it's not funny on the radio.
We can't hear that.
This is the room that Tom Chiasano is in, and I've been spending my day doing Tom pictures. And here they are.
You think this is going to get you a job here?
Absolutely.
That's the general manager of the radio station.
Yeah. What the hell? I have a lot of confidence. I figured if I could break his balls and still get a job, it just shows how great I really am.
You got to see these. This he hung on the door where Tom hits the button on our show. Look.
Uh-huh.
Stay out. Show being ruined. And like he hung them all over the door.
That's good.
And Tom yelled at him, and then like even Sal went,
like I'm going to even get this job. Right, who cares? Right. Let them yell at me all week.
Here's another one. Must press dump button. Must press dump button and a big dummy picture of Tom. And here's Tom golfing. I whack the button like a golf ball hung up. And then this one's my favorite. It's Tom going, here comes Tom. Time to end the show. Oh. But my favorite is stay out, show being ruined. That's funny. Now that
Thank
is
you,
funny.
Harris.
That's good stuff. Here's Tom trying not to smile. Go ahead, Tom. Well, I'm sorry. Yes.
Tom, you know, Tom goes along with anything for the show pretty much.
All right.
But Tom's not going to be disrespected by someone.
Okay. You're talking about yourself
not
in the third
way.
Person?
Tom is
only
not
because
gonna,
Tom is not going to be disrespected.
Right.
Tom will
I know now Cabby
anything.
Can call in.
Tom, you were born disrespected.
You're such an idiot, you know?
You're so rude. I mean, everybody has been really great and polite, but you're the only guy in the hallways that you just roll your eyes when you look at me. You're like email with legs.
I saw you first in the morning, said hello to you, and there's just nothing likable about
you. Is that how
you
say hello? What is that, some Zimbabwe way of saying it?
Nothing. If there's anything like about you, I would respond to the likability in you, but I don't see any.
I hope cancer comes back in your nuts.
Oh, that's uncalled for. Right. Don't you want it in his brain?
In good taste, and if good taste ever invaded your brains, and if there were any brains between those ears of yours, then maybe it would come out.
So, Tom, what happened? You had to yell at Sal?
I didn't yell at Sal. I don't want to deal with Sal when he writes something. When he writes stupid things like that.
Tom told me, and I
went to Gary. I said, you know what? He's crossed the line, and I'm not going to have the line.
You are ruining the show, though. The sign, that is funny. That hanging over where you dump the button and goes, stay out, Tom ruining show?
No.
Howard, I originally had douchebag at work.
No, that's not right.
That wasn't
right.
Nice. That's why
that
I did it.
Right.
That's why.
That's wrong. That's over the line.
Your sensitivity really knows no bounds.
Listen to me, stupid.
Wait a second,
Sal. You're not going to be here long.
I'm only kidding.
You know what?
That's
no,
not
you
funny.
Know what? And you don't kid like that. You know what? Mm. You have no right to say that.
You haven't earned the right.
I apologize, Tom. But notice that when I wrote douchebag at work, I used better judgment and didn't use it. And instead,
so for that, I should congratulate you?
No, but I'm keeping...
You didn't see any
I'm
humor
keeping,
at all.
Right.
No.
I'm just keeping you in
you
mind.
You got to admit, show being ruined is funny. I don't care what you tell me. That is funny.
And you
That's
whacking
funny.
The dump button with a golf club?
Oh, that's a riot.
That's funny.
I have to say, Sal consulted me on the douchebag at work one, and I said, that's over the line, Sal.
And who knows that better than you are?
I did. I said it's over the line.
All right. So Tom has had a run-in with Sal, and...
Can I be the better man, Tom, and apologize?
No, you could never be the better man, Sal.
Okay, because I'm not apologizing.
Good. And you could never be the better man.
Nice tie.
Thank you.
Why don't you try to run your throat?
Yeah. Ooh. You know what, Sal? And you go back and enjoy and bilk somebody else out of stock money, okay?
Ooh. Oh, you see, you have to go there. Is that not? I'm trying to keep this in the content of the show by making pictures of you with a dump button. I'm not going below the belt. I took away the sign that said douchebag. I took away another one that had to do with cancer. I apologize. What else can I do?
Leave.
I will eventually.
Okay, good.
All right. Well, Tom having a run-in with Sal, the stockbroker.
Obviously, this is not going well.
Tom. All right. Tom.
Okay.
Thank you, Tom. All right. Let's play Sal's game. This is Sal's chance to win the job.
How could you be fighting with Tom already?
I like Tom. I don't know. Wow.
Well, you've gotten off on a bad foot. That's the expression.
Uh-oh. Here comes number two. Tom times 100.
Tim, go ahead. You're on the air.
What's up, Howard?
Hey, brother.
How's everything?
Okay, go ahead.
Real quick, I just want to make sure you're not turning homo on us here, talking about Casey's how good he looks in a swimsuit.
I don't want to sit by the pool and hear the women go, oh, this is such a treat. Casey has a shirt off. Who needs that? I'm trying to look decent. And
we know Casey's a homo, but we can't lose you too, Howard.
Don't worry about me, pal. I'm all man.
I love how you guys can't handle it if there's a really good-looking guy.
I can handle it fine. Just tell him to leave.
Yeah, just leave. Zolar, you're on the air.
Yeah, I wanted to call in when goddamn Tom was in. I called him at his office yesterday.
Zolar called him at his office?
Yeah, he gets on the phone after his secretary puts me in there, and, you know, I said, hey, listen, Tom, you know, I don't have anything against you personally. I just started the conversation like that. And he's like, I don't care if you like me, you know? And then I'm like, hey, listen, I don't know the rules and regulations. I'm not a professional broadcaster. He says, well, the regulations and rules come from my head. It's what I deem indecent. And I'm not putting you on the air, but Howard wants you.
Mm-hmm. Whatever.
Poor Tom's day is with Bobo and Zolar.
Well, you know what? Good.
I can't wait to sit next to him in Vegas. Make his life miserable.
See you in Vegas, Zolar.
You will, dude.
Later. That's Zolar. Great. I like that guy.
Zolar's great.
You better like him or else he'll annoy the hell out of you. So, Sal, what game do you have for us? This is your audition, in a sense.
Yeah, well, what I did was, I know we have to do a revelation, so what I did was I privately interviewed everybody, and everybody said what annoys them most about Gary.
Okay.
We've taken the quotes, and we have to see if Gary could guess what person is annoyed most about his attributes.
All right. Now, are you going to be able to play these back? You gave them to Fred?
Yeah, the order's in the order that I say.
Oh, I see. I have it. Okay. All right. Well, you're going to play. Gary, I guess you are the victim.
He's going to say it, and I guess I
have to guess. You'll have to guess, and then he'll play the tape, and you'll hear it in the person's voice.
All right. This will be comfortable.
It's what annoys me most about Gary.
All right. Let's play, Sal. Let's see how it goes.
Who said, when he laughs, he takes a lot of air in his nose, and it causes him to snort like a pig?
That's true. Now, but which one of you said that about me? Oh.
Who's actually his choices?
Yeah, what are all
Howard,
the
Robin.
It's the crew here. Right. Howard, Robin, Benji, Fred, Artie, okay. Ronnie, and Casey.
All right.
I'm going to go with Fred on that one. I could see Fred notices little things, and it's not really an angry thing, so I'm going to go with Fred.
Let's see if you're right.
Sometimes when Gary laughs, he breathes in so much air that his nose makes a snorting noise. And he sounds like a pig.
That's, I guess, KC's.
KC, so that's one
complaint.
Wrong.
Okay.
At right, every so far, it's good.
Right,
I'm enjoying the game.
Thank you. At every commercial break, he bursts in and monopolizes Howard without anyone else getting a word in edgewise. He just keeps on going and going without taking a breath. And we should be all thankful for that.
It's either Howard or Robin. I'm going to go with Robin on that one.
You think Robin would say, though, without a breath, without taking a breath, and we should all be thankful because she's making fun of your breath? That sounds a little not Robin-like to me, but all right, you say it's Robin.
Anybody else want to join in? Artie?
Oh, we can all play?
Yeah, I mean, if you want to.
Well, let Gary. Let it be Gary.
Okay. But Gary's the main one.
All right, let's find out.
Yeah, we're going with Robin.
I'm going with Robin.
The thing that annoys me most about Gary is how he just commandeers Howard's time and he monopolizes it so that no one can get a word in edgewise. He does a body block if he sees you coming so that he makes sure he keeps Howard's attention. And then he speaks nonstop Robin. Without ever taking a breath.
It was a sentence. They asked for a sentence, not a novel.
Yeah. Well, they asked for a normal set of teeth, not for the Great Wall of China.
Hey, you're a good host on this show.
Thank you, Howard.
This is his game show.
This is your game show. You got to admit, for those people who wrote hate mail about Sal, this is a good one.
Yeah. It's good.
I'm giving you a 10.
What did you think of yesterday, Howard? You didn't write yesterday's bit.
I thought it was very funny. I admit it.
We could see it, too, so maybe it needs the visual. I'm not sure about that one.
I think people sitting home heard the kids, and we were describing the toothbrush going into Gary's mouth. I thought it was pretty funny. It's going to be better on E, I'd give that a 7.
The part that I thought was the funniest about it was the kids. When the kid was yelling, get your stinky breath, that was really funny.
That was good. Sal could have done more of that.
There's nothing more humiliating than what you did yesterday.
Thank you.
Oh, yes, there is.
Thank you.
He's got it hooked up for later in the week.
I give it a 7. I give it an 8, maybe, even. You know, it was good. I think you did well.
Production bits so far, would you consider?
I'm considering you a strong candidate.
Thank you.
But it's the audience you have to win over. Go ahead.
I didn't know that Harvey Leitz has a dental operation where he's making toothpicks. He actually called me yesterday. He wants to patent, pin the toothbrush on the mouth.
Oh.
And actually distribute it. He's dead serious about it.
You might make some money off this. Off your new Gary game. All right, go ahead.
Okay. Who said he is an a-hole, he's selfish, and he's self-absorbed?
Ooh.
Wow.
Who are my choices again?
This crew. Ronnie, Scott, and KC.
Wow. Yikes, I can't imagine who that might be.
You sure Lewis isn't in this game?
He is not.
Just kidding.
I
got to go with Scott.
I'm going with Scott on that,
too.
Yeah,
Scott.
That's the only person I could think of.
And also, you just added Scott's name in. So
that really rocked out. Your lips were quivering on that one. It really
He's an a-hole. He's self-absorbed, and he's selfish.
Oh, my goodness.
See, I don't see that.
From the workaholic.
I don't get that. Why do you think Scott said that?
Because I tell him to work, and when he doesn't, I get mad at him.
Wow, that's strong.
He's an a-hole, he's selfish, and what?
Self-absorbed.
I don't think you're self-absorbed.
I don't either.
Not you at all.
You seem to be mostly absorbed with me.
Thank you, that's my job.
Right. I'm self-absorbed.
He's certainly not selfish. He's not any of that.
When I went to Scott yesterday to record this bit, he was on the phone booking his vertical blue band for the 100th time.
Right.
And he yelled at me to get the hell out of it. How dare I come in on the first day and demand that he get something done off the cuff?
Because he's busy with vertical blue.
Yeah, all day.
And all day.
I can't believe he's not going to come down here and defend himself.
I don't know. There's a couple of times when I walk in the studio, where the window he's working on closes very quickly, and there's music playing that doesn't sound like anything.
He
we're
really
using.
Did something underhanded yesterday too.
Why don't we lie, huh? Why don't we play that CD I gave you, Casey, of him directing everybody and telling them what to say?
There's nothing wrong with that. I'm doing my job.
Did you not say that? You mean he told you to say that?
Yeah.
So you not
do you believe? But do you believe it?
No.
Oh,
well, wait a minute.
That's no fun.
Wait a minute. Hold on.
Why don't you throw me under the bus?
I will. Yesterday, I went in there to play the bit.
He walks in and he expects me to. I'm in the middle of something and he expects me to do it right then.
You were on the phone booking Vertical Blue and I sat there for 15 minutes.
Dude, you got to stop.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Do that at home.
I was working.
Scott, do that at home with your son's band.
Wait a minute.
Not here.
I don't do that.
We have stuff for you to do.
That's not the end of it.
If you got time for Vertical Blue, then
I don't have time for Vertical Blue here. I don't do Vertical Blue.
What really bothered me is that he said his son couldn't get booked at a particular club, so he uses Fred's band to open up for them so they can get the spot.
What the hell is wrong with you?
And Fred is a professional. He doesn't plug his band. 50% of the audience doesn't even know he has a band. Yet he's a gentleman enough not to do it, and all day long you're on Vertical Blue. I'm trying to get a job here, give you the bit, and you're yelling at me, throwing me out of the studio.
I don't know what
You're saying those words weren't yours, the a-hole comment about Gary?
He didn't come to you and say what's the most
Wait a minute, that's not yours?
Gary.
The annoyance on Gary is not your words?
Well, I said it because you wanted me to.
But wait a second.
That's
hold
a
on.
Blatant
hold,
lie. I can't believe it.
Sal, swear on the life of your children you didn't put him up to that.
I swear on the life of my children. He said straight out he's an a-hole.
Casey, play the other CD that I gave you.
What are you talking about? The other CD would be me saying I recorded Scott yesterday and asked him to re-record it today because my MP3 player crashed. You're a manipulative piece of crap.
Me?
How could you say that?
I don't know what you're talking
about. And in the hallway, you said you would deny anything I bring up today.
You don't even work here.
You're an idiot. Your son's band should be My Dad Sucks. You know what?
I believe Sal.
Dude, really?
Yep.
All day.
I work with you for 18 years, and you believe him?
I think you're lying right now. I think that those were your thoughts about Gary. I think you're pinning it on Sal, but I think you
Sal was going around annoying everybody and trying to get everybody to say something bad about Gary.
Well, yeah,
so that was the
game. So
I just went along and I just played along with the bit.
All right, so it's your words.
The bit should be genuine. It should be like Gary's always busting in, but if that's what you think, that's a tough one.
No. Please. I mean, you know,
Sal didn't write that for you.
I thought of it, and then he said, "Say something bad about Gary." I'm like,
"Say something annoying." You are so retarded.
Not really.
The question was,
"What annoys you about Gary?" I'm like, he goes, "Come on. You could think of something."
No, I could shed some light on this. What Sal did do is he asked you something, and you just said it. And when he wrote what he wanted you to say in the quote part of it, and he really exaggerated what you said. Like, he made it more vicious.
No, originally...
Right, can we move on with the game?
Yeah,
who cares?
It sounded exactly like what Scott said.
It just bothers me that he uses Fred's band as well to
I don't use Fred's band. I don't even know what you're talking about.
I was there, stupid.
Well, here's a big question. Robin, with what you said about me, those were pretty much your thoughts.
Yeah.
Were you directed?
No.
Casey,
I wasn't directed.
No, I totally came up with that on my own. That's the snort. We didn't hear it yet.
Isn't it funny that everybody knew it was Scott when you heard A-hole and he says he's being directed towards it? Yeah, you're a real Mother Teresa.
No, I came up with it because he was like, we got to come up with something that's negative about Gary.
All right, so that's fine. But he didn't put it in your mouth.
No, I didn't say he put it in my mouth, but
yes,
then he was directing me on how
he wrote it and told you to
write
say
it. I said it because he said, come up with something that's,
Scott,
go. That's something I came out with and said I wanted to say.
All right, thank you.
It was just something.
I was trying to know if that you meant it.
None of us wanted to say this necessarily. It was just a game.
Having heard that, I have to think that the thoughts are kicking around back in your head, even if you made them up.
Can we get on with the game?
You know the thing I did with John when I said I didn't like John and he got all upset about it? It's the same thing.
Can I get on with the game?
Yeah, let's go.
Thank you. All right.
You really hated John.
Go have a cigarette. It's time.
Go book your son at the Nobody Cafe.
Is that VerticalBlueMusic.com? Can't even say
it. Oh, come on, dude. Come on, stop it.
Cut it out, Jackie.
Yeah, really. Goodbye. What's the matter with you?
Your son's band should open for Jackie. Two nobodies in a row.
Go ahead, Sal.
All right. Who said he hijacks every conversation?
We're playing What Annoys You About Baba Booey. Baba Booey trying to guess
who said that.
He hijacks every single conversation.
I'm going to go with Howard on that one.
Is that your final answer?
That's my final answer.
All right.
Fred, what do you find most annoying about Gary?
He hijacks every conversation. Every conversation.
Well, there you go.
Too wrong.
I said when somebody says you talk too much, I figured it could be anybody in the room.
No, that's
sorry, Fred.
I got you. It's not talks too much. It's hijacking the conversation. There's a difference. And what I'm talking about is...
I love this. I just love
this. This is actually... I actually have to thank Sal for this, because there's no way you can ever bring this up except in a game format like this.
Which you can bring it up.
Which makes me feel good. No, because then it just, like, turns into something else. Anyway.
Yeah, this is more comfortable.
Look at Gary's wet.
There have been times when... And Robin can attest to this. I hope she's not going to bail on
it. Oh, I won't bail.
Yeah. There have been times when I've been having a conversation with Robin. I'll be, like, in mid-sentence... Gary will cut through like a saber, stop the conversation, direct the conversation to what he wants, drop his bomb, and then leave. And I'll look at Robin and go, what just happened? Am I exaggerating even
not
the least?
All. Not at all. Oh, he does
thank
that
you.
A lot.
He did that with Artie. He actually stepped in the middle of Artie and I one time. And I'm like... What happened here?
Because you guys need help talking.
Maybe the lighting is bad in this part of the studio. Maybe his hearing is bad. Maybe his hearing is not tuned in to where he hears.
Is this just like a private conversation?
Yeah,
or like
it has nothing to do with the show. It's not like I understand why Gary has to speak with you during the program.
You're talking about just in private.
Just, you know, hanging out, having a conversation.
It'll be after the show. You know,
it'll be after the show.
Why do you get involved?
I don't understand it.
I don't know.
And you know what, something? I like Gary. I think Gary is a fascinating conversationalist. But that's the one pet peeve that I have.
But, Fred, do you think it's fair to say every conversation or a lot of conversations?
Maybe I misspoke. Let's say a majority of the conversation.
How about some? Let's go with some.
Let's say a lot.
Okay.
All right, let's go to the next one, Sal.
Here we go. Here we go. This one's a tough one.
Sal hitting a home run.
I'm in ha-ha heaven right now.
It's the quietest he's ever been. He just lights a fuse and walks
he's
away.
He's doing good. He's letting it happen.
Okay. This person said, he can't stand the way you clear your throat.
Well, that's obviously Howard.
That's right.
There's a bunch of things that really annoy me about Gary. I mean, I could probably point out when he... like looks over my shoulder and his breath is all over me, but I think the most annoying, and he's going to know this, is when he clears his throat. Every morning he clears his throat and says, and you can hear the phlegm gargling up while I'm trying to eat. That's for me the most annoying.
Can I tell you something about that, by the way? Yeah. When I'm driving in the morning, right, coming down the West Side Highway,
right
about the time I get to 125th Street, I start thinking about it. I swear to God, I start thinking about it. And it's like, I think about it, and then all of a sudden...
It's a psychosomatic thing.
It creates
something that wasn't there.
Right.
Now the whole ride in, I'm like... and I'm drinking water like crazy. But I don't know, the West Side Highway makes me think that this is another one of those mornings where I'm going to annoy Howard.
Right. I mean, there's so many things, like when sometimes Gary will just plunk himself down, like when I'm ready, like I'm just going on the air. And he's not doing anything wrong, but he's just sitting there. And he's trying to keep his teeth covered with his lips.
He's doing it now.
Yeah.
When he gets nervous,
and then he's trying not to attract attention. Then he gets a weird side smile. And then I go, oh, my God. And then he's like.
See, you could have gone on and on and on.
Yeah.
When he closes his lips, it looks like he's holding on to like a cliff for dear life.
I got to tell you, not only do I give this bit a 10, we should do this with everybody.
Oh, yeah.
That's good.
Marty.
Thank you, guys.
That's not bad.
Everybody should get me on the seat
Sal,
with this one.
We'll all thank you at some point.
Go ahead. Let's finish the game. It's a good one.
Thank you. All right. He shakes his wrist above his head, and he doesn't say hello in the morning.
Shakes his wrist above his head. Yeah. That's got to be Benji.
He shakes his wrist over his head in the morning.
Oh, Ron.
A lot of times when he's walking down the hall. And a lot of times he doesn't say good morning.
When I walk in, Ronnie's behind glass.
Like a monkey.
I wave to him.
Right.
Instead of screaming hello.
It annoys him.
It's a weak one.
Go ahead.
Okay.
I forgot Ronnie was in the game.
I can understand that.
Okay.
He's hardly here as it is. Okay. He repeats the same old stories.
That's got to be Benji.
He repeats the same old stories.
Artie.
Dude, you're so off.
Listen, here's why I'm sensitive to that, because I'm guilty of the same thing. I repeat stories constantly.
Oh, don't take it back.
I'm not saying...
Own up to your complaint.
In the world of being a hijacker and everything else, repeating a story is nothing.
But Sal did embellish that one. I said he repeats stories a lot, and he goes, all right, he gave me a line reading in there. He goes, now, I want you to go, he repeats the same old story.
Yeah, you know who does that, too, is Artie. He does that a lot. Probably because a lot of things you tell him, you're probably like really drunk. And
Artie laughs at his own stories. That pisses me off.
Does that annoy you?
Well, he'll always go.
But dude, why don't you explain?
I thought we were waiting for the.
We're not there yet, right, Artie?
Oh, guess who says this, Artie? He laughs at his own stories.
I'm fat and drunk.
I'm the direct opposite of John. I actually deflected it from Gary onto me.
Yeah, exactly. All right, come on, Sal. Finish up the game.
Well, there's only one left, right?
There's only one left. Wow, you're good, Robin. Okay, here we go. He has a tendency to be very dismissive of thoughts other than his own.
That would be Benji.
He has a tendency to be very dismissive of thoughts that are different than his own.
Yeah, well, Benji.
Sounds like a politician.
I can understand that with you. Some of those thoughts.
I take a lot of Benji thoughts.
All right, we'll play this with other people on the show. That's very good, Sal.
You just started something.
Just case.
I got the CD of him directing us.
Yes.
If you want to hear some of that.
I don't care. It was a home run.
Yeah, why ruin what was good?
I think it was my job too, to direct and to get a good bit out of it.
I think you did very, very well.
Yeah, he was trying to make us concise, that's all.
Let's go to Scott. Scott, you're on the air.
Hey, Howard. Yeah, he's got some major problems. Why is he attacking everybody? And he's got to work with these guys. It doesn't make any sense.
He's mixing it up. He's trying to get John's job, man. He's just trying. Chauncey, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hey, by the way, I'm proud of Sal because this means a lot to him. You know what? The guy is hitting a home run day after day.
Oh, good.
He's doing good.
Thank you, Chauncey.
He really is. Hey, let me tell you something. Scott the engineer, he really does hate Gary, and that's no joke. I was in the sound room last week with Scott.
Mm-hmm.
I wish to God I had my recorder on. Scott hates Gary.
Well, expand.
Well, he has a lot of issues with you, Gary. He feels that you don't do your job, that you really just don't do anything there, and that you want things done right away, and then you walk away, and you don't finish what you start.
Hmm.
That was his big complaint. You don't finish what you start. You'll throw something at Scott, and then you just won't care about it. You'll walk away, and then you won't help him do what you want it done. And it drives him crazy.
All right, there you go.
Yeah, he really doesn't like Gary at all.
All right, listen, we're going to... Hey, Howard, what is it, Casey? I got to take a break, yeah.
Hey, Howard, I got everybody's name in a hat. You want to pick for tomorrow?
The Sal game, you mean?
Yeah.
It should be a regular game.
You pick.
All right, for tomorrow, it's Fred.
What's the most annoying thing about Fred?
Anybody want to play that game?
You only have to say one thing?
Hey, Howard.
Yeah.
I have a request. And for my celebrity interview,
okay.
I would like it to be in the studio live Thursday with Beth. Now, I would like the fans to email me their favorite questions, and I'll cherry pick the best five, and I'll ask them to Beth live.
Well, I don't know if she can be here live, but you can maybe she can send to an interview on the phone.
Okay, my Beth interview, if you would allow it.
I would allow it. It's up to her.
Okay.
I don't control her.
She is a celebrity.
That's
true. You want the audience to submit questions.
Or at least getting banged by one.
If she says okay,
cool,
Gary, man. Write her an email and ask her if she's interested in that.
Okay. She's your girlfriend. He's got to write her an email?
Yeah.
I guess
I'm going to go home and remember
he
that Sal
wants to make business with pleasure.
Good point.
I'll forget about that 2 seconds after you say it.
Thank you, guys. And
all right.
Thanks,
thank you, Sal,
great
the stockbroker. Day two of Sal, the stockbroker, coming in with a winner, a 10.
Thank you.
If you like Sal, vote for Sal.
Of course, I'm going to hate that game when it's my turn.
Well, I've already taken a few hits.
Yeah, you already know some of the things that could be said about you.
We'll be back right after this.
How do you think that went?
It went great, man. I'm really happy about it, you know. Just being truthful, doing what I do, creating bits. I'm glad it mixed up really good. Yeah, I'm a little worried, you know, because the fans are tough, but I think I can win them over. At least I hope so.
Howard said that was a 10.
There's nothing better than the king himself saying it's a 10. I did my job. That's what I'm supposed to do here, so I'm real happy with that.
Do you think those things were true about you?
I think there's a grain of truth in some of the things that people said. You know, I know there's a grain of truth in some of them, but I got to tell you, I was telling Casey, you know what? I take it personally. I do. I get a little bummed out about it. By tomorrow, it'll be another day, and I'll be over. But I do. Nobody wants to hear what's wrong with them. I pay a shrink for that. Not my friends. My alleged friends.
So when people say like you interrupt conversations and you're rude.
I think it's true that I interrupt conversations sometimes. I don't think it's true that I do it all the time. I thought that Benji's was really, you know, Benji has lots and lots of ideas and not all of them are home runs. So I guess when I don't take one that he likes.
Mike Walker phone call.
Yeah, I get Chrissy in here, the foot fetish model. How's she looking? You guys seen her?
No, I'm curious, though. This sounds fun.
Hey, Howard, she's up for anything?
Yeah.
can I chew up an egg sandwich and spit it on all of her feet?
No. I mean, yeah, go ahead.
All right.
Get ready.
And I'll blow a few snot rockets on her feet, too.
Oh, geez.
If she's up for anything.
I'll stick my whole mouth over her feet if she wants.
Never.
Yeah. You'll put her whole foot in your mouth?
Yeah.
You haven't even seen it
after
yet.
After the egg sandwich?
But she's not a guy, Reggie.
You into feet?
Yeah, I love feet. I've messed around with feet before.
Women's feet?
Yeah.
Were they attached?
I love feet one, and cheesecake.
I don't even know if I could say this, but one time I made a mess all over her feet before.
Man, that guy was
pissed. And a chick like
it wasn't my own feet.
Okay, I'll tell you what.
It was your own feet. I made a mess on my own feet.
Oh, yeah.
When you put the foot in your mouth, does it get you off?
Kind of, yeah. A little bit. I like licking the toes and stuff.
I love when the knuckles are hairy, like the foot knuckles.
Okay.
When he comes in here, would you put David Spade's foot in your mouth?
I don't know, for maybe some money or something, if he shaved them.
What are you saying, David has hairy feet?
Well, a lot of guys, I do. I got hair on my toes.
I will take a chubby pickle.
You know what we ought to do? We ought to take the foot fetish chick, put her behind a curtain, put 3 feet, like, there. One is hers, but two are guys.
Uh-huh.
And he has to pick the foot he wants.
Yeah.
You have to blindfold him, though.
Oh, whichever no. foot he picks, that's the one he has to lick.
Yeah.
I'm going to dip my feet in the toilet right now. Watch it.
Oh, no.
Well, how about I spit my egg sandwich and a snot rocket on her feet, and you have to eat it all?
No, I would throw up all over her feet.
That's great.
Unless
radio.
She's into that.
Hey, that's a big E show.
Maybe that's the last E show.
Yeah, do yourself. If you vomit on her feet, man, that's a guaranteed
you
E
know,
show.
You know, I could probably make myself vomit right now thinking about that.
Oh, yeah, think about it. Let's see what happens. Sal takes his chewed up eggs, spits them out on her feet, and blows a few snot rockets, and you stick it all in your mouth.
I don't want to just... If I had a trash can, I'd probably, like, do it, but I don't want to...
And then
we're telling Richard this, and then when it happens, he's all surprised. Like, whoa! Oh, yeah, that's... what are you doing?
All right.
I said, they're the greatest comedy team ever.
Richard, will you do it?
Thank you.
Will you do the egg sandwich, snot rocket, foot deluxe sandwich?
What do I get out of it, though?
Pleasure.
The foot!
The E-show.
You get this girl.
Oh. See, I'm almost like hurling now thinking about it.
Try it.
Come on, dude. It's
if
me.
You want to see me vomit, I'll do it.
All right. Yeah.
Once again, it's Faggot and Costello.
This is a garbage pail.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
I'll
wait till I see it, though. I'll wait till I see it.
All right, listen, we got to take a break. We have a lot coming up, obviously. A lot of big entertainment this morning.
Yeah, don't go away.
But here's the... I better just go to commercial. Cause
yeah. The mic walk is ready, Howard. It's cute.
I know it's ready. I'm running out of time. I got to get to the commercials.
Okay.
You know.
That's like the first happy call we've done where somebody wasn't angry afterwards. That guy was like really happy.
Where we weren't being sued.
What are you talking about?
The Mike Walker call.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, he was like enjoying it.
Hello? Hi, this is Rod Stiffington from the Jack and Rod Show, and I'd like to welcome you to Name That Tunes Tuesday. Tuesday. How you doing?
All right.
I'd like you to welcome my co-host, Jack Mayhoffer. Say hi, Jack.
How you doing, Mrs. Jackson?
All right, how you doing, Jack?
Do you listen to Jack and Rod every day?
Well, I ain't gonna lie, not every day, like every other day.
Oh! I don't know if you're really getting our drift there, Miss Jackson. If you just say that you do, then there could be big prizes on the line.
Big prizes.
So let's ask you one last time. Do you listen every day to the Jack and Rod Show on WFAD?
Yes, I do.
There you go! All right.
Mrs. Jackson, do you realize you could win
$5 million?
So you like music, right, Miss Jackson?
Yes.
Okay.
Now, here's the rules. My partner, Ron Stiffington, is going to play you 3 songs. You need to tell us who sang those songs, and if you get all 3 right, $5 million! Yeah! Are you ready, Mrs. Jackson?
Yes.
Here is your first song. Who sings this tune?
Elvis Presley, and you'll get it right.
Mrs. Jackson?
Oh, no. Is that Elvis Presley?
Yeah! Yeah! Got it! Yeah! How you feeling, Mrs. Jackson?
I'm feeling good.
Two more songs to go.
That was kind of a tough one, too. So you got one out of three. Listen carefully and tell us who sings this song.
Who sings that song?
Was it Michael Jackson?
Just think, you are on a roll.
Here it is. Here is your third and final song. Do you realize, Mrs. Jackson, if you get this right,
$5 million?
$5 million.
$5 million to you, Mrs. Jackson.
Name this singer.
Is this Beatle? Is his fattest dad? He knows he's the best.
Oh, God. That's a hard one.
Big prizes on the line, Mrs. Jackson.
Is James Brown?
No.
Okay, so sorry. I don't know. Oh, is that Chevy Chester?
Oh. You want to know who that singer was?
Who?
It was Beetlejuice.
Oh.
Do you have any Beetlejuice records?
I don't even know Beetlejuice.
Jack
and
riding
you a couple of
fools. Oh, that isn't nice.
Just tell you something about these two guys here, Howard,
yeah.
Cowboy and Tonto.
Cracking and Costello.
Howard, this is so creepy weird. So they go to get changed. They don't even go to the men's room. They go into the Lewis's studio.
Right.
They get butt naked in front of Lewis.
Oh, my goodness.
And then they look at each other's packages and sort of discuss them.
Wow.
Discuss, like, you know, who's better.
We talked about shaving and stuff like that.
All right, you guys, strap her in. Let's do some tickling and foot worship.
Can I ask her, what does she think of us? Like, does this turn you on?
No. Do these look like your usual clients?
I think you're a total riot.
They look pregnant. Well, go in there. Let's see. Guys, tickle her feet before you vomit all over.
Every day for 4 weeks, I've seen Sal's ass at work.
Yeah, this is, and he's trying.
I know. This is Chrissy, the foot worship girl, and she's having a party in Allentown, Pennsylvania this weekend. If you want tickets, you can go to hotandsexyfeet.com. Hotandsexyfeet.com.
Did we establish if she can make a good living from this?
Yeah, she says she can make $1,000 a party.
But so how many parties are there a week?
10,000 a week.
Howard, can I ask her a question? Would you mind taking off your panties for this?
Yeah, I don't want to take them off.
Okay.
All right, stop touching yourself, all right?
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
His thong is real itchy.
Yeah.
Don't look too close, because I'm trying not to, but that thing that Sal's wearing doesn't fit, so everything's hanging out each side.
Yeah, he's adjusting
it's just some
and
hair.
Itching and everything.
Looks like Al Sharpton in my pants.
All right, look. Hotandsexyfeet.com or 609-280-8657. Now, Chrissy, we want to understand foot worship, so who's going to tickle her feet? I'm too lazy to get up. I want to watch.
I want you to do it.
You do?
Yeah,
I'm so bad at it, though.
Well, Gary was pretty good.
Gary, you're good with the tickle thing.
It's a big fantasy of mine.
Tickle her feet. I don't care.
Let Gary do it. Forget me.
It means nothing to me, so I'll do it.
You won't even laugh if I do it. Boy, she does look young.
She does. She has a very
young. She is young.
She looks 15.
She's like, you know.
All right, Gary, you ready?
Yeah, let's get those shoes off. Those shoes are sexy.
As Gary tickles, I'm going to start eating this egg sandwich.
I still don't know how they go into a back room and come up with those get-ups for this bit.
Uh-oh, Gary's already tickling.
He's not a good tickler. I wouldn't know her to do it. No.
Come on, make her laugh, Baba.
Apparently, she keeps looking at my face.
Well, my face ain't going to help.
Oh, I love your face.
Really?
I do. I love your hair, too.
Thank you. All right, let me get over there and see if I can.
Yeah, maybe you can do something.
Maybe Gary could tickle her feet with his tongue.
Hey, which Hazel those feet? But Gary just touched me. All right, I'm coming over.
Soap them and bleach.
Oh, what's that?
That's Sal's egg sandwich. She's going to spit it up all over her feet. And then Richard's going to stick the whole foot in his mouth.
Or at least try to.
All right, let me see. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. Here we go. Are you ticklish at all from that?
I am ticklish. I think maybe I'm just a little nervous.
I don't know. Is that happening at all?
I think Gary was doing a better job than
I know. I don't know how to tickle your feet.
I really
Gary, yeah. Get her.
How about under the toes?
Yeah, that's...
Get her, Gary.
I'm trying. I mean, she's like... She's dead.
Yeah, Gary does a better job.
Wait, I got a feather. No. Yeah, here we go. How's that?
No, Gary's fingers.
Are you ticklish other places?
They're tickling me more.
All right, let's get Sal do his thing.
All right, took a little with your lips.
All right, now, Sal, what is your fetish here? You want to spit up? Describe what you're going
to
do, Sal.
My fetish is to eat an egg sandwich.
Yeah.
Load it with saliva. And spit it all over her feet.
Yeah.
And then Richard Christie, my
assistant. Richard, what are you going to do? You're going to put her whole foot in your mouth after he
spits that stuff on it. But
any luck, you'll vomit.
I'm sure I will.
All right, Sal.
Sal's ready to deliver.
Go ahead. Deliver it onto her feet. Go ahead.
Oh, God.
Oh. Oh. Now hold your feet still. Hold your feet still.
Oh.
Richard's already gagging.
I can't even look at it.
Hold your feet still. All right, now Richard.
Awesome.
All right, Sal.
Get those eggs, you pig.
Potter.
All right, what have you done? You spit and you put egg all over her feet.
Oh, I feel great.
What did you do? Did you spit?
Oh, I felt so good. I really feel a tingle in the bottoms.
Answer my question.
Yes, I'm sorry, Howard.
Did you spit and put and spit eggs and spit all over her feet?
Yes, I did.
All right. And, Richard, you wanted to put her whole foot in your mouth. Go ahead.
Yeah, I can't even look. Yeah.
All right. Go ahead. It's a foot omelet. All right. Get the mic
on. Don't go up on my feet.
He might. Get the foot in there. Get it in there.
Oh my god, you're pathetic.
Yell at him.
Let me help. No.
Oh, put that foot in your mouth.
Wait, there's some egg on my finger.
Richard,
you can do
Richard,
it.
Don't you want to kiss
your
feet?
Do it.
Richard, listen to me.
Come on, we have a gun, okay?
Oh, God.
Richard, don't you do it.
Are you sure you want to leave it at that? You don't want to kiss her
Let me
feet.
Try this other foot.
All right, go ahead. Sal just sprayed mayonnaise all over
my,
it.
Right, on, my ear.
Go ahead and worship. Sal's throwing up.
What a prick.
Go ahead and worship. Put that foot in your mouth. Put it in your mouth.
All that mayonnaise will make me puke.
Get up. This is disgusting.
We don't have all day.
Wow, that was some session. Well, what would you charge for something like that?
Oh, man.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
what a mess.
Oh.
What are you saying, Robin?
He slobbered all over himself.
No. Well, Chris.
The worst moment in the history of broadcasting.
That was fun.
Sal kept riding him like a pony, and forcing his head into the
car. Trying to go around.
Throw it on, Richard.
No, no, leave her alone. Leave her alone. Hey, Sal, stop. Stop.
Sal, stop.
Sal caught a cockroach and put it on Christy.
But Sal got sick. What made him? Oh, no, he's putting it in Richard's
You put it in your thong.
Oh.
No.
That's my worst nightmare, cockroaches.
In your thong.
And mayonnaise.
Well, Chrissy, you've been a great sport. We've learned a lot about the world of foot worship. How was that for you, Richard?
Excuse me?
How was that?
Oh, it was a nightmare.
You look vile.
My ear is full of mayonnaise.
And so's your wig.
Look at him.
Sal, thank you, of course. And Chrissy, thank you for the great foot fetish lesson. And we wish you luck at this big event. There's going to be a foot worship party, and you're up for a good time. Was that the most outrageous foot worship you've ever had?
Yeah, definitely.
You're not used to guys vomiting during it, are you?
No, never.
I think you're going to have to witch hazel your entire body.
I would have to get an exorcism.
Yeah. Did you enjoy that in any way, Richard?
It was, I mean, it was interesting, but, like, I don't know, it was nasty. I'm not into feet that much.
What made Sal sick? He was doing all, he was the perpetrator, and then all of a sudden I saw him retching.
Sal's got the cockroach again.
Keep that away from me, I swear. I'll knock you out.
Stop it.
You guys are crazy.
All right. Listen, Chrissy, thank you so much.
I have a question before I go, though.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of the show.
Thank you.
And I miss you.
We don't like him. We don't like him.
Oh, really?
We don't like him. Screw him.
Hey, listen.
You're a good sport.
Thank you.
You were very sweet to do this, your foot fetish thing.
This was fun.
And I got to tell you, you are a lot of fun. We're going to have you back here for some more foot worship.
Awesome.
We had a great time.
That could be the last E-show.
That might be the last E-show.
That might be the last television show ever. Period.
All I know is I'm looking at her feet now. They're covered in egg vomit.
Ooh,
spit.
Everything.
Yeah. We'll get you some witch hazel, hopefully.
Mayonnaise.
And go to hotandsexyfeet.com and also 609-280-8657 if you want to see Chrissy and her friends at the Foot Worship Party in Allentown, Pennsylvania this weekend for fans of feet, which is a whole thing we don't even know about. And Richard, thank you for showing us foot worship. And Sal, thank you. What are your characters' names again?
Cowboy Christie and Tonto the Stockbroker.
Okay. Yesterday, Richard and Sal were in here, and they went all out gay when the guys from Jackass were here.
All out gay.
Richard and Sal painted their penis. They painted each other's penises. One is a Howard Stern face and one is a Gene Simmons face. And I got to say, Sal's penis looked really strange as Gene Simmons' tongue. It looked like
I was going to say, you couldn't get that out of your head. Once you saw it, it was with you the rest of the day.
Yeah, it was pretty weird. I said to Richard, what was that like? He goes, yeah, I painted his penis. And
finger painted.
Did he?
Yeah.
Oh, you're kidding.
They touched each other's dick. They were finger painting.
No.
Yeah, no, that's definitely what happened.
I think that was brushed on. He did that with his fingers?
Either Jason or Will told me they finger painted each other's cocks.
Oh,
touched their dicks.
God.
Well, then they are doing it.
Then they're gay. That's it. It's over. I mean, it's just over.
I thought you knew that.
No.
No, you see, that's why I was sitting over here ready to throw up yesterday.
Were they getting aroused?
I don't know. God, who knows? I don't know.
Hey, I'm going to finger paint you. That's not gay, is it?
Yeah.
And that means, you know, you got to lift it to get under it. That's all kinds of manipulation.
I think, they absolutely...
Let me rub it.
...lifted their cocks and finger painted. Yeah.
Dude, you're a homosexual. I'm not kidding.
There was a big glob of paint on my finger. My actual finger didn't touch his penis. The paint was...
Dude,
like
you were massaging his penis. It's like using oil on it.
It was purely artistic.
Did he get aroused at all?
No.
Did it grow a little? Sometimes did he go, did it feel good?
Did you have to get more paint?
No, it was small the whole time.
And you guys think if you leave the door open, it's okay. You know, like it's like...
Yeah, you have a bunch of other guys watch you. That's not gay.
Yeah, it's not okay.
We were just laughing the whole time. It wasn't.
So
there was nothing erotic about it.
That's true. That's a good analogy. It's like oiling up his cock.
Yeah.
But it's paint.
Yeah, but it wasn't like I was grabbing around it. And
not yet.
That was a big step for Sal. He's never shown his penis on camera before. Mm-hmm.
And he was like, oh, people won't be able to tell that I'm naked. You know, it looked, you can't tell.
What?
He thought since it was painted, you couldn't really tell he was naked.
Uh-oh.
You know, they really are getting like that Joe Rogan bit. Oh, it's not gay.
That's not gay. Let me put my penis in your ass. It's not gay. Wow.
Oh, yeah.
It looked hilarious, though. I have to say, I was pretty proud of my paint job on his package.
Yeah, you did a good job.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sal's a good guy. Getting really close.
I love painting his cock.
I got to play some bits for you, because Richard keeps reminding me we're way behind in our bit playing we got.
You know what? Just to go back to this, I just want to show you this picture of Richard touching Sal's penis. Oh, it is so disgusting.
Let me see that. Yeah, there you go. Well, that says it all. There's your answer.
Okay.
There it is. There you go.
Before those pictures, but they are gay.
What's really gay is Sal has big tits.
He does. He's not in good shape.
Look at the tits. He's got like no chest definition.
Yeah, he's like...
Well, there's a picture around here somewhere where he really looks like, you know, he's one of the topless girls. He's on Richard's back over there, and his tits are out.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Look, that's a B cup right there.
Sal's penis look funny because it's uncircumcised? Uh-huh. Is that what's going on?
That's what he says. He's glad he's uncircumcised because it made it really look like Gene Simmons' tongue.
Yeah, there you go.
Way to go.
I'm just not used to seeing that, you know? Although I believe in it. I believe you should be uncircumcised.
Well, you're looking at it now. Would you like to look down and see that?
I'm used to a circumcised penis look. It's been my look my whole life.
Yes.
So, you know, it would be freaky all of a sudden to see an uncircumcised penis between my legs, but I get why it should be there. I mean, circumcision is some horseshit thing somebody developed to cut down on the sex. You're trying to curb men's sex lives.
Yeah.
You know, I know that. But I got to admit, it does look a little odd. Looks like his penis looks like it got fried off or something.
I mean,
like
we think we're out of control with sexual thoughts now. I mean, but there was a time
better.
Where people go, look, we got to do something.
We got to get men under control. We'll cut off the sensation in their penis.
Because when a man is horny, it clouds your mind. You can't think straight. I mean, you know, when you got to fucking come.
Oh, it's just awful.
It is.
You got to just get all that poison out of you.
It's a curse.
Yeah.
It's really funny. I can't remember the guy's name, but he was one of these great thinkers.
Yeah.
And, you know, he was like 90 years old or something. And the reporter said, do you have any regrets? He goes, yeah, I wasted all that time on sex.
Right. Yeah, right.
He couldn't think when he... And this is a great thinker.
Life could have been so much more full.
Well, he said he could have gotten a lot more done in his life.
And guys who can't get sex are busy jerking off. You're busy coming on some level.
Did you see Jim McGreevy on Oprah speaking of sex?
Oh, my goodness.
I only saw some of it because I was sort of in and out of my apartment yesterday. But well, here's the rumor I heard on Richard. He was telling somebody in the hall. You talk about the creepo factor. Richard, by the way, is on Inside the Porn Actor Studio tonight at 7 o'clock. The show's a scream. Andy Dick's got the shit show tonight at midnight. And we are going to re-air the Dice Artie show on midnight.
Wednesday.
But Richard said to someone, his favorite invention is the video iPod because I can take it on the plane with me and jerk off to porn on the plane.
Are you serious?
Swear to God. Richard, man, that is just vile. I mean, have you no shame?
Has he really done that?
We're dealing with...
He said it in private to Garrett.
Can I add one more thing to that?
Yeah.
That
makes retarded adolescence.
That makes it doubly creepy. He goes, yeah, it was a big plane that had two bathrooms, so I wasn't really keeping anyone out.
Dude, this is so gross. You're like an animal. Can't you just like not beat off for like a plane ride?
Yeah, for a couple of hours.
Like, but go home and beat off?
Well, one of the reasons I do it is I hate to fly. Yeah. And that really calms my nerves. Like, I drink.
Hey, I'll tell you what, don't fly. Yeah. Give us all a break.
It is disgusting, man.
Take drugs, like everybody else. You're jerking off?
What do? You take the video? Do you sit on the toilet and do it?
I stand up and do it.
Over the sink?
Into the toilet.
How long does it take? Oh.
And it gets all over the
especially
place.
Especially those bathroom
toilets. No, I flushed it.
Horrible.
Oh, you're vile. You're just a vile
But
dog.
It wouldn't flush down my seed, and I had to get like wipe it with toilet paper in there to get my seed to go down.
Fucking vile. I want to die.
When's the last time you showered?
Yesterday. Because I got real sweaty on the plane because I'm
my
real
balls and
you because you were jerking off.
Well, that and I'm so nervous about flying. I sweat a lot, my not hands and my balls.
Let me tell you what these guys were up to. So they're at the airport. Where'd you guys work?
San Diego.
Yeah, so they're at the airport. So what they did to kill time, you know, when they have the guy, the announcer guy on the well, you know, on the friggin' announcer thing.
What are you talking about?
You know, at the airport.
You can page people.
The public address system. Yeah, the public address system.
Okay.
Richard and Sal started giving fake names. Now, this is really hard to hear, so I'll probably have to give you some of the names, but it's just so funny. Harry Wong.
He's supposed to say Harry Wang, but...
All right.
Because don't make the announcement of the game.
Did you take that one out?
Harry what?
Dr. Harry Taint.
Oh, okay.
They bust this guy's balls all day. How many hours were you there?
For 45 minutes straight, just dialing him over.
You gotta be careful, because sometimes they get, you can get like arrested.
We were worried about security. We were.
You gotta be careful.
Miss Lick My Pussy? What was the next one?
Cleveland Steamer.
How can you think Cleveland Steamer?
Because the guy was a dope.
I don't know. What's the next one?
I love Black Cock.
No, he doesn't say
Olive. I swear to God.
Olive Black Cock?
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
All you got to do is just call in, right?
Yeah. And when we said Olive Blackcock, it didn't come up right away, so I panicked and called him back. I go, sir, I can't find my wife. He goes, relax, Mr. Blackcock. I'm going to page you right now.
All right, and I'll give you a triple play here. The boys made a... How do you do this? You take all of Mike Walker, who does the gossip game for us, you edit his voice up, and then you call people?
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
We're working on Tracy Morgan right now. He's got some
that's
going to
be great.
Stuff. Real quick, Howard, I'm sorry. Richard didn't shower all weekend. We did four shows, all smoky clubs.
Right.
Drank, passed out, threw up a couple times in his mouth. So we're leaving Sunday.
Choked on his own vomit.
Yeah, so I shared a room with him Sunday. I get up in the morning. I brush my teeth, hoping he's going to catch on. I rinse. I go, Richard.
Follow the leader.
So I go, Richard, are you going to brush? He goes, yeah. He reaches into his pocket, takes out a piece of gum, pops it in, and he goes, let's go.
Oh, dude, why do you have a hygiene?
Well, they make gum now that's supposed to, like, help whiten your teeth and stuff.
Come on, Richard. You just went through all that oral surgery. Don't you think it's time to take care of your teeth? What the fuck?
I do.
You still have cavities to get rid of.
Use your brain.
You're going to just get some more.
You got a girlfriend now, man. Even though you're not physically with her, just like maintain your oral hygiene. You never know.
Yeah, I had mouthwash and stuff with me.
Yeah, but what's brushing your teeth takes 2 minutes.
I have one of these really...
Feels good.
I have those really expensive toothbrushes with the motor inside them, and I don't want to break it by taking it
just
on trips with me.
Take a regular toothbrush, man.
He's always got an excuse.
He
doesn't want to break his toothbrush.
You're like when my kids were two. You know?
And how expensive is the toothbrush with the motor in it? You sound like it's 1910. I got one of them motorized toothbrushes.
All right, so how many hours does it take you to chop up Mike Walker's voice?
Oh, this took forever. I mean, this was days. Like, we'd spend about 3 or 4 hours a day calling
people. This is tough
work.
When you walk into their room back there, this is what they're working on. This is Mike Walker calls a bakery.
Hey, can I help you?
Hello.
Mm-hmm.
How are you?
I'm good.
I want a classy cupcake, Keira Knightley.
Mm-hmm.
Plus a large piece of sheep sperm smothered in hot fudge and ice cream.
A classic cupcake with what? I'm sorry.
I want a small penis smothered in warm Godiva chocolate liqueur.
Sir, I'm sorry. We don't do those type of things.
I want a large Beach Boy type smothered in hot fudge, plus a big, fat, black penis smothered in squirrel shit.
What are you asking for? Are you asking, are you wanting to place the cake order, or what are you
yes.
asking for? Mm-hmm. Are you, from what I heard you say previously, was something an X-rated cake, and we don't do those.
I want a small penis smothered in warm Godiva
Sir,
chocolate
we do
liqueur.
Not do those.
Plus a big, fat, black penis smothered in
Sir, we chip. Do not do those.
Come on. Is there a problem?
You're saying a classic cupcake, and then you say a black penis. Well, we do not do that, okay? Can I help you?
I want 18 girly nips, plus 400 pounds of volcanic goo. Yeah.
Who the hell is this?
Taylor Hicks.
I'm sorry, we don't do those.
Don't you know who I am? I'm the American Idol. Hello?
Sir, we spoke about this earlier. I don't know what you're asking me to do. We don't do X-rated cake. So if you can think of an un-X-rated cake order that you'd like to play, then mm-hmm. we can do that. But I can't. I don't understand what you're asking me to do.
Okay, I want 2 frozen hot weenies plus 18 big shit cupcakes. Yum yum. Dessert, anyone?
Sir, we don't have cupcakes.
Get out of here.
I love to laugh when he hugs up. Yum yum. Dessert cake. He really says that shit.
All right, dessert, anyone?
I'm taking a break.
That's great work, guys. That's very
yeah, real nice job, guys. I'm going to take.
Now, let's go on a happier note. Someone has a present for your birthday now. His name is Richard Christie. He works on our show. He's the new member of our cast.
Yes. Do I have to accept this gift?
Well, he wants to come in and sing. And, well, he told me what it was. I can't even believe what is about
to
happen.
Oh, no.
But here he is. This is Richard Christie. Here he is. He's in a towel. It says on his skin, on his bare skin, "I love Robin."
No, and he's got a towel. What is?
Oh. No one can hear you. And he's totally nude now.
He's
nude.
Are you out of your mind? Put your towel back on, you dope.
Please listen.
You
to
are
Robin.
Totally naked, right, Richard?
I'm totally nude for Robin for her birthday.
The hell's
I
going?
Love you, Robin.
He gave me a card that says, "I love you, Rob. My love for you grows with every year."
Yeah, now you are totally.
He
wrote me a note and said, "I want to be naked for Robin and I want to sing to her." And you're wearing a party mask?
Uh huh.
Don't I get to spank him at least?
Yes.
My birthday present?
Yes, you do.
Yes.
Give me a big oar.
If you want. Come on out here, Robin. Come
By
on.
The way, that thing between your legs isn't very...
Yeah, what are you giving me?
Hey, not much.
I think I've been shortchanged.
I was looking at a dirty magazine back there trying to get a little bit like more
Do you
excited.
Shave it all off? Is that what...
Yeah.
You shave all the hair?
Yeah.
That's because you watch so much porno, man. That's not cool.
It makes it look bigger.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
No, it makes it look deformed.
It's cold in here.
Don't you think that, like, I'm not gay or anything, right? Yeah. But don't you think that when a guy's got a towel on and he, like, whips it off, there should be a bigger payoff?
Yeah, you think, you know, Lexington Steel
right.
is coming
it was
in here.
Anticlimactic.
Were you disappointed in what you saw?
Very disappointed.
I think all of us were disappointed.
I mean, you even sang about girth today. There's not even that.
There's nothing.
Hey, you give me a few minutes to get excited.
I ain't much bigger, pal, so I gotta tell you. All right, why don't you do your song new?
Why a mask? Okay. Are you ashamed?
Yeah. I don't want my parents to see my face.
Yeah, no one knows who you are.
These pictures.
All right, you're there nude. Your legs are spread. You're proud of what you got. That's a gift to Robin.
He looks like
I've got a little whip here. If Robin really wants to come out and spank me, I'd be all up for that.
Nails in it or something.
Why don't you sing your song before we waste the audience's time some more?
Okay.
There's important things to discuss. Go
ahead. This is for you, Robin. I love you.
And here we go.
He puts on a low voice.
Oh, I see. I'm up to the music. All right. Richard dancing.
Robin's breasts aren't fake. They look like 2 huge chocolate cakes.
Nice.
Every bounce they take, every bra they break, I'll be watching them. Happy birthday, Robin.
Every bra they break.
When I see those mounds, I grab my and I'm covered in sweat as I make a mess. Yes, I must confess.
Dancing naked.
Yeah. Robin, can't you see? I love those double D's. They made my nether regions ache every time I see them shake.
Looks like they made your nether regions go away.
They look like huge chocolate cakes. Every bounce they take, every bar they break, I'll be watching them.
You're very comfortable naked, aren't you?
Yeah, I feel great.
Benji.
Robin, wow. Happy birthday. I love you.
Right, thank you.
Thanks for joining us.
You're welcome. Are you totally comfortable naked?
Yeah. I feel fine.
I feel better naked than you do in
public. Yeah, if I could walk around like this, I would.
Go ahead. I dare you.
That's like top five most disturbing things I've ever seen.
Well, I figured dancing was good if you don't mind me saying. Yeah.
Well, do it for Howard's birthday, too.
Yeah, what an honor. All right, Richard, what do you think of that, Artie?
I don't know. I'm trying to eat every day. It's some more nudity, but it's all male nudity.
I'm with you, Artie. What's going on?
I mean, you know, you could have done that in the thong or something, I think.
No, come on. It's Robin's birthday. This is special.
That was for Robin.
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
Certainly wasn't for us.
I mean, if you really wanted to do it for me, you'd have had Brad Pitt come in and do it.
Right.
I bought Robin's shoes, and the shoes are too small, and so is Richard's gift. Everything is too small.
Sal's out there. He's got his gift. He wants his gift.
Oh, no.
Oh, I saw this. You know, this guy's such a fake. Somebody sent me this plaster cast thing where you can make a mold of your genitals.
Right.
So Sal made a mold of his genitals for your birthday, and I know.
You know it's not his.
He stretched it out. Right. You giving it to her?
Yeah. Did you actually touch this? I don't want it.
This is a mold of his actual. Look how big this thing is.
The box is too big.
Right.
Probably for what's. Oh my God. That's disgusting.
Why don't you make a real mold? That's not.
That can't be real.
Yeah. That's just so not you.
Certainly not his.
Yeah.
It's me, but then it deflated. I pulled it out of the mold and I left it in my drawer, my underwear drawer, so my wife wouldn't see it. And I guess the heat got to it, and it just deflated.
Right, that explains why it's half the size it should be.
Right.
But why is it, you know, 10 times longer than we all imagine?
I might have pulled it a little bit when I was fixing it.
Oh, so you did a little extra sculpting?
Yeah. If you look,
that ain't on your mantle.
No, I was thinking it would be really nice if you could hang it from the mirror in your car.
You know what? Come here for a second. I
hit him over the head.
Wait, I just want you to see something. All right.
Uh-oh.
Oh, what's she gonna do with that?
She's gonna beat you with it, you idiot.
No, It's stuck to the paper. It's wrapped.
Well,
I want to show you. First of all, this is pretty much my size.
No, give me this.
I knew she was going to hit him in the head with it.
No, I heard someone do some crazy stuff making it. Like, what happened with you and your wife while you were making it?
I wish there was a camera on that.
It's nothing but
beat you in the head with your own mold.
It's nothing but penis and male ass. It's a barrage.
All right, guys, come on. Enough. Get out of here. I'm going to play for you.
I just took care of myself.
Let me see what else I got here. Play for your birthday. For that, or do you want to hear Jack FM making comments to me?
Oh, really? Jack talk back?
Or you want to hear some more of that Jackie stuff?
Jeez, let me hear Jack talking back first.
All right. All right, let me set that up then. Where's Jack? Where's my Jack FM CD? Do you make that mistake too? I always call CDs DVDs.
Yeah.
It's annoying.
Yeah, so they all look the same.
Yeah, they need to come up with new names that are less confusing. Let me see. Richard and Sal fight. I had to break up a little thing going on between those two jackals.
Are they fighting for real?
I was in the hall, and they were yelling at each other, and it turned out Richard was doing something with Vinny, and Sal got jealous. So Sal goes in and pulls the plug on a computer.
Oh, my goodness.
And has a tantrum that, how dare you do a bit without me?
You're kidding me.
With two women. What?
He pissed me off yesterday. That was about the maddest I've ever gotten at him.
I've seen guys hock loogies in each other's face.
And they don't get this upset.
Right.
It's not what happened.
Dude, you're a woman.
Dude,
Vinny and Richard are working on something. Give it up. Go do something on your own. You're like a goddamn wife.
You can't work with anybody else?
Not what happened.
Such a little
pussy. He kept walking in and out like pacing. He was pacing that we were working together.
Put a bra on.
I saw it.
Hey, I saw it.
You saw it.
Did you pull out the computer?
Yes.
Why?
Because
Richard and Vinny were doing something without you. Why? Why'd you do it?
And why would you do it?
See, this is the problem.
Richard all day long. When I'm working on stuff, editing things on my laptop for the show, Richard comes by and he smashes into my keyboard. He tries to shut it off.
I'll come over and tap on your keyboard, joking around, and a little pop-up window will come up, and that's it.
No, one time I was in the middle of editing a prank call. He hit something. Everything froze. I had to re-edit a 30-minute prank call. He laughs. Fine. I can deal with it. Fat Vinny the Pig comes in. I ask Richard if he wants to go to lunch. He goes, I want Vinny to hear some of my old songs first. I go, fine. He pops in the CD of songs, and I pull the plug on the computer.
You know what, man?
Touche, faggot. Touche. And you know what? And I do.
You know what Sal does, too, right? Before we even start listening, he goes, what do you need to let him listen to that crap for? Like, already.
And you know why else you're a girl? I'm going to tell you why.
Why? Because I got
because you're such a girl. You write me a note the other day about an idea you have. I don't comment on it for 24 hours. You run to Booker. Here, do this. Howard doesn't want to do it.
You're kidding.
Wait a minute.
Come here. Look at me.
It was
you're
a throwaway.
Gay.
It was a throwaway.
You're gay.
I'm gay because I gave Booker a crap idea that you don't like?
No, I don't care if you give Booker an idea.
Gay.
Dude, you're like angry and upset because someone doesn't use your idea.
You?
Just calm down out there.
I'm calm. I asked him, a friend of mine, to go to lunch, and I pulled a prank. He's been pulling on me for
months.
Because
he was with Vinny.
No, F Vinny. I could care less about
it. I never shut off your computer.
Did I interrupt you?
And then we didn't have the password for the computer. We couldn't get back in.
Get out. Quick question. When I walked by the office yesterday, did I hear you saying to Richard, I can't believe you would take Vinny's side over me.
Yeah, like, he was crying to me. He goes, I'm really disappointed.
Well, he's gay.
I was sad. Please. I love Richard.
Go home to your wife. Go home early.
Can I just say one other thing while we got him in here that's wild? Wait a minute. I don't like what's going on here. It's all wrong.
But why,
everything is wrong.
Why would I side with you when you're in there pulling the plug on me and Vinny's computer?
Something down.
You know, Robin, I could be with 10 strippers tonight.
What
a faggot.
You want to know something?
On Richard's computer.
But you were crying about it afterwards.
I'm gay no matter what the F I do.
Well, all right, get out. You sound like Angry Black and King of All Blacks.
No, all right, talk. Can I explain your side?
I'm going to explain it to you. It's not a side. It's the facts. I walked in on you guys yelling at each other. I saw the situation. Vinny and Richard were doing something without you, and you're like the child who has to get in between his parents. So you pulled the plug on the computer so you could get some attention.
It's not
now
true,
get out.
Howard.
Get out. I
want to
play Jack FM.
Don't get the last word in because it's
get
your
out.
Open show. It's not fair.
Get out.
I would have loved to have Sal in there with us, but I had to tell him to leave.
It's fine to be without Sal. You're not his wife.
I know, but he can't stand it.
Your mic is off. Get out.
Give me a reach around here.
What did you say?
Go ahead.
What did he say?
He'll use Booker's mic.
Oh.
Can I tell you one other thing?
You know how, like, we always think, like, you know, Sal's sort of getting it now.
No, he's not.
He came to me with a request, like, 5 minutes ago that was so bizarre and off the map. But he said, hey, listen, I'm learning because usually I would have just done it without you. He wanted to know if we thought it would be a good idea if I called Donald Trump and if Donald sent a helicopter to pick him and Richard up on Saturday to bring them to Scores.
In Baltimore.
So I said, you're kidding, right? He goes, no, Trump's got a helicopter. I go, why would he want to do that? He goes, it'd be great publicity for the show. I said, Sal, you're out of your mind, right? He goes, hey, usually I would have just called him. At least this time I asked you.
Oh, he's retarded. Go ahead.
Helicopter!
All right, here's the guy from Jack FM, as you know. Well, I'm going to have a party. They're not invited.
Oh. There's a guy in New York.
Meanwhile, Sal's out there sucking up to my cousin. It's embarrassing.
Are you serious?
My cousin's interning here. He's like a 19-year-old kid.
And Sal's like...
Sal's putting his hands on him. He's like, everyone is out there cracking up. Sal's sucking up to my cousin.
You know it's getting
stuck. No, you're not going to end up at my family Thanksgiving with my cousin. Forget it.
Sal is helping your cousin.
You're mentoring
Everybody
him.
Everybody is coming in to tell you that so you could break my balls.
You got your hands on his shoulder.
All right, I will not work with your cousin. How about that?
You've now taken him under your wing.
I'm trying to do the right thing. He's a good guy.
Sal's all over it.
I'm finding out all about the family barbecues, buddy.
There's never been a family barbecue.
Really?
Yeah. So you haven't found out a goddamn thing.
He's
the type of kid who's quiet.
He's a good guy. He's a real good guy.
Yeah, you're not going to get anything out of him.
Let me ask you this. Has Sal ever done another bit with an intern? No.
That's true.
I mean, you're sucking up to my cousin. It's not going to work,
so
Sal. I don't want you part of my life. I don't want you in my family.
I'm helping the guy out. I'm doing a production with him.
Sal, when have you ever done a production with an intern?
It's something I started due to your cousin. He's motivated me to do it.
Don't the other interns need the kind of assistance?
He has the Howard Stern blood. It's important for me to stay close to it.
You're
psychotic. That's what's going on, by the way. He's not kidding.
He's joking, but he's not joking.
We're going to lunch later.
Yeah.
Are you really?
Yeah, why not?
Oh, my God.
Howard Stern's cousin.
It's Blake.
He's going to be a member of one of your families if he can't be in your family.
Bring my cousin in here. I want to set some guidelines.
You love him. You
what
don't
is
even
it, Richard?
Know him.
I was originally going to do this voiceover for this bit we were working on, and Sal was like, oh, no, wait, let's have Isaac do it. Let's have Isaac do it. Wow. He was all excited about it.
Yeah, I want him involved.
Dude, Howard, what are you doing, Howard? Why are you now holding your head in your hands?
You're retarded.
I want Isaac involved. I like Isaac. He's a good guy.
You're a retard.
Poor kid.
Don't
you
say
let
that
him in.
Christy. That's not nice.
No, talking about you, Sal.
Oh, all right.
Isaac.
And after he was done, he was like, great job.
Oh, yeah.
Isaac, let me explain something to you. Sal is psychotic. Sal is obsessed.
He's a nutcase.
Sal wants to get into my house, into my life, watch Survivor with me at my house, and sit on the couch
he's
next to me,
you.
And he's willing to be naked with me. And give me hand release, okay? That's this psychotic man. He's never once paid attention to an intern. He's never once allowed an intern to voice anything on a bit. And God bless you, you're a good kid, but you don't have a voice like some announcer or something.
I think he sounds great.
Stay away from him. You hear what I'm saying?
I hear what you're saying.
Yeah. Just do your thing, but stay away from him.
See, all the other guys out there are after the girl interns and Sal's after.
Yeah, forget the girl.
I'm after the talent.
He has a Stern out there.
The talent is what makes this show go.
Well, how did you discover talent? How did you discover his talent?
Just look at the blood running through his veins.
What if I told you he's not even my biological cousin?
I'd throw him out of here.
All right. See what I mean?
I'm looking out for number one,
all right,
Mr. Stern.
Sal, stop it. You're embarrassing yourself
you
out there.
It. You stop.
How old are you now?
20.
Yeah, 20 years old. Leave him alone.
Yeah, I feel like I'm molesting the kid. I'm working on productions.
You just started today. You're like a pedophile. You started today working with him. Right. What's next? Going out to dinner, drinks?
I desperately want to make love to a schoolboy.
Are you going to take him to those stupid booths you go to?
I'll tell you what.
I don't want you near this man.
Let's put the star witness on the stand. Isaac, how are things going between you and I? Be honest.
Well, I guess.
There you go.
Very good.
I might have the insight, though.
Does Sal frighten you at all? Or?
Do I have to answer that question?
All right. Listen. Leave him alone.
Go back to your room.
Treat him like everyone else.
Jennifer Tilly told Sam Simon to leave the Simpsons alone.
Okay.
Come on. That's sometimes your advice.
What does that mean? What does that
mean?
Mo?
Sometimes you're not recognizing, a diamond in the rough. And that's what we're looking at here. Howard never had a son, but he has a nephew.
It's not my nephew.
Oh, your cousin, right.
He's a cousin.
Yeah, whatever. I don't pay attention to these things. You should know if you're in love with him.
Well, Sal wants to be my son.
I am
It's not going to happen.
I'm your son whether you want it or not.
It's not going to happen as long as Isaac's around.
You know how kids have divorced themselves from their parents? Well, I have brought myself, my bloodline, into Howard's life. I am now officially your son. I think Sal's hoping that if he gets in good with Isaac, Isaac will invite him to one of the family functions.
Oh, yeah, then he'll become a family member somehow.
Sal's insane.
I'm calling you Dad from now on.
You're a creep.
Sorry, Dad.
Steve, you're on the air.
Yeah, Howard.
Yeah.
Hey, now. This man, you want me to take care of him? Just nod your head, or just give me a...
Oh, no.
I'll take care of him. I'll get rid of him for you, because this man is nuts.
We got to pay...
Okay, we can handle it.
We got to pay attention to Betsy, too, but
Yo, Artie. Yo.
What?
Yo, when you were on Mad TV... And you did that bit with the kids when you were a baseball coach?
A bookie.
That was the funniest thing I ever saw in my life.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Okay. I'm sorry. I called you twice last week and
Artie
I busted your
all
job.
Humble.
Yes.
Thank you. My greatest work.
So what do you want me to tell you? I happen to write that sketch.
That's my Mona Lisa.
I played a bookie at a Little League game.
Anyway, Isaac, thank you. Go ahead. Go back to being a regular citizen.
Stay away from Sal. That's one.
Stay away from nutjob Sal. Yeah,
yesterday, when Sal found out he was your cousin, he perked up right away. He's like, he's his cousin?
Come on, Isaac. We're going to go read Private Parts together.
Oh, wait. Sal, how much of this is, like, kidding around?
None.
None of it, right?
Zero.
Because if that's the case, then,
you know,
man.
I'm working with the guy.
He's a kid. He's a, you know, he's just...
What am I? Sal, when have you ever worked with an intern?
Things change. Maybe Isaac.
You're insane.
Isaac opened my eyes to make me realize that there is talent in interns, and that's what Isaac did. He's already.
Sal, I want you to come clean right now. What's going through your head? Be honest. Sal, block everyone else out of this conversation.
Okay.
What was the thought process? Be honest.
The thought process was, he is an intern. You say, I don't work with interns.
No. Sal, I asked you to be honest.
The thought process was, I thought he could be potentially good to do the bit. Bottom line.
Sal.
No stern relation.
Sal. Stop it. Out of all the interns back there, he's the one. What was going through your head? Don't talk to Richard. Talk to me. What's going through your head?
Nothing.
What did you think? What was the fantasy?
Nothing.
Talk to me about the fantasy.
No fantasy. No
fantasy. There was a fantasy.
No, because you have a look in your eye like you're ready to get rid of me.
No, I'm not going to get rid of you. I want you to be honest with me, though. What was the fantasy?
There was no fantasy, man.
Isaac's a cousin. Maybe he'll like you. Maybe he'll say something
Isaac's
nice
a cousin.
To me about you. Sal helps me. Sal's a good guy.
That's a little weird. But
what was going on? I want to know the truth. Because there's plenty of male interns here. So let's be honest.
Well, there's another male intern.
I don't want to talk to you.
Okay.
All right.
Give me the real fantasy.
We're in the back. There was a bit that came up. Isaac was there. I said to Richard, how do you want to do this? And Richard said, I could do the voiceover. And I said, why don't we have Isaac give
it a shot? Why Isaac?
Because he could potentially be good.
Why Isaac?
Not because he's your cousin.
Well, hold on. I could add a little insight into this, Howard.
He's not being honest now.
Isaac's back there being a production intern today. He's moving around. So today is a production intern. There's been production interns here since the day you got here. Have you ever utilized any of them for anything?
That's what I was going to say. The other production intern that's in here today has a deeper voice than Isaac. I don't know why Sal didn't want to use him.
If you don't want me...
When are you going to come clean and tell me why Isaac?
If you don't want me to help your family, I won't.
But help everyone.
I am sorry.
So you were going to help my family?
I was going to help people who work here, part of the show, and show them
the
ropes.
No, but wait. You wanted to help my family.
And who have you ever helped before?
Hold it. You wanted to help my family.
Is that wrong?
Why don't you help the other interns?
I do.
No, you don't.
All right.
So the real reason you got involved... You want to help my family, Howard Stern's family.
That's a nice thing to do.
Okay, listen to me. I don't want you to worry about Howard Stern's family.
Okay.
I don't want you to worry about helping Howard Stern's family.
Okay.
I don't want you to think about Howard Stern anymore. I want you to think about
your
work.
What did I tell you earlier today?
Robert, could you give me an upgrade on where you think that problem is right now?
Jodie Foster, John Hinckley.
Oh, please. I wouldn't hurt a fly.
I don't mind being Jodie Foster, as long as I'm not Ronald Reagan.
Right. The problem is everybody around you.
I would hurt myself
and
before
the,
I hurt
the rest
anybody.
Of the world, because John Hinckley decided to pick on the president to get Jody's attention.
But, Sal, don't say you'd hurt yourself either. That means you're psychotic.
No, I'm saying I would hurt myself before I ever hurt anybody.
I don't think you're ever going to shoot anybody, but it's the same syndrome.
So you figured you'd help Isaac because it would help someone in my family. And then the fantasy is that...
You're proud of Isaac. It's nice to have somebody family here, and I'd like to help the family. I'd like to help. I don't know if that's a bad thing.
Could I ask you to help the family?
Well, who helps the family? Family members.
I'm family. I'm his son.
All right.
I'm joking there, but if you don't mind...
Not really.
When will you convert to help?
The family as in our family?
Right.
Okay, look.
The Howard Stern family.
Howard Stern family.
When the contest was over, you used to make references, the Stuttering John contest, that we're going to welcome these guys into the family, the Howard Stern family.
All right, so can I ask you a question? The whole big family, that we have a family every semester, a family of interns.
Is the intern group in the family or just Isaac?
The interns have the potential to be in the family.
Isaac is in the family.
Right.
Isaac's already one step ahead.
Isaac's your favorite.
Isaac's my favorite. He's a good guy, and he's got great potential.
How do you know he's a good guy?
Nuts.
I mean, he seems like a nice guy, but he's only been here
today. Yeah.
Leave your hands off him. Stop putting your hands on his shoulder.
I don't do that. All right. You do.
Bobo, what is it?
Hey, how you doing there, Howard? Bobo. Hey, Sal, you are deranged. If you keep on this path, you're never going to make it to Satellite in 6 months. You're getting too involved in Howard's family. Back off, man.
Bobo Buckwald.
That's Bobo. I'm telling you, you're getting too involved. This dude, bitch, you're good at what you do, but you're getting too involved in his personal life. He's going to drop you, man. I'm telling you.
Thank you.
You're going to lose a good thing.
Thank you, Bobo.
All right, bye-bye.
You'll lose your toupee before I lose my job.
I don't know about that.
He seems to be holding on to that toupee pretty tight. Oh, yeah.
So all right, thank you, Sal. Thank you, Richard. Thank you, Bubba Booey. And we'll.
And I apologize, Howard, if you took it the wrong way. I'm just trying to help, but I'll lay off.
Just do your job.
I'm sorry.
Don't worry about my family.
I don't want to creep you out, man.
Thank you.
And I'm not going to.
You're not creeping me out at all.
Thank you.
Jesus.
Oof.
What else is in the news?
Words of my Aunt Tess Marone.
Nothing as creepy as that.
I'm going to let you play the drunken Miss Howard Stern game.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Now, it's very simple. You've got to match up 3 out of 5 with drunken Miss Howard Stern.
All right.
All right. Let's hear what we got.
All right, let's stand up. Let's do this game. You can do great, honey. You look fantastic.
I just want to see if she's really going
to... Okay, ready? You look beautiful. How much school have you gone through?
I'm done.
Now, how much school did you finish?
12th grade.
By the way, how creepy is Sal?
I was going to say, who is that creepy guy? Doing the question.
You look beautiful.
You look beautiful.
Go, go.
Yeah, exactly. That's the same guy.
Yeah.
So phony and sleazy.
Just a smarmy guy.
He's so smart. He tried to have phone sex with Nicole Bass the other day.
Oh, stop it.
Yeah, I'm not kidding.
You know, the thing I wonder about Sal, I was watching Howard TV, which is awesome, by the way.
Thank you.
And his wife is way too hot for him. What's the deal there?
That's what everybody says on the Stern Fan Network, too. I read that. And they all say that Sal's wife is way too hot for him.
Do you ever see her making, trying to get your attention when Sal's not looking to say, help me?
On Howard TV. Let's, as long as we're into the creep factor on Sal, you want to hear him trying to seduce Nicole Bass?
Yeah, I got to hear that.
Yeah, right here. I'm interrupting the game just for this call. Listen.
Hello?
Nicole.
Yeah?
Hey, it's Sal.
Hi, Sal.
What's up, honey?
I do appreciate you calling back. I hate to sound like a wimp, but I've always, taken really good care of myself and have never, ever had health problems until 2000. I mean, I had pancreatitis.
Well, let me tell you something, Nicole. I saw you recently, and you know what? I have to tell you, I think you look really, really good.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
I know
I'm not Vogue magazine material, you know, but...
You know what? You still are very womanly. You're a woman. You have big breasts. You have a nice, round, voluptuous ass.
Thank you.
Yeah. Right. Hey, what are you wearing right now?
I just woke up. I'm naked.
Wow, that's hot. You want to have some fun?
Don't you even get me started. Sal, I know you too good. I can't fuck you. It's like when I...
Let's go. Let's get some phone sex going.
No.
Come on.
No.
Come on.
You know what? Remind me never...
No. No.
That's so funny.
I'm not going to do it.
I'm going to call you again in the future.
Shut up, you fuck. Listen to me.
Don't you fucking tell me to shut up, you fuck. What the fuck is wrong with you? You
know, some of that cock, baby. Come on.
13 years, Howard never got me to take my pants off. Okay?
Let's see that dick, baby.
Yeah, you wish I had a dick. It would make you feel more like a man.
Come on, whip it out. Jerk it, baby. Yeah. Come on, give me some of that hard cock. Let's roll.
Give you something to jerk. I'll fist fuck you. I take my fist and just shove it right up your ass so you never fuck again.
Now you're talking like a man.
That's what you deserve.
Fist my ass, baby. Mouth.
Kiss your own fucking ass. Kiss your ass.
Come on, coach. Fist me.
I am some asshole. I'm not going to just do something.
Come on, let me hear those balls jiggle over the phone, buddy.
Yeah, jiggle this.
Oh. What the hell?
Sal's doing the jerky boys guy, Rizzo.
What's that, Nicole?
I'm not playing your game, Sal. Kiss my taint.
All right, let's get back to the game. What did you want to say, Gary?
I was going to say, you know, after, you know, last week Sal told that intern that, you know, she said, what do you want for breakfast? He said, you want a bagel?
Yeah.
I had a conversation with Sal in my office, you know, and I just said, listen, it's a different world we live in. I was explaining to him what sexual harassment is, and he goes, really, that's sexual harassment. He goes, I don't see it. He goes, I think sexual harassment is, hey, come over here and suck my cock. But I didn't think that was it. So, of course, after I had this conversation with him, I found out he's walking out yesterday, and the receptionist is eating an apple, and he goes, an apple a day keeps the doctor away, but it won't keep me away from you. And I'm like, you don't talk to strangers like that.
Shut up.
Shit.
All right, let's get back to the game.
12th grade. No. 12th grade. Nope. 12th grade.
Okay. All right, here we go. So you know that Miss Howard Stern has a 12th grade education. She's inebriated. And now let's find out what she knows.
Yes, she got that at home, that education.
All right, but nevertheless... She
wherever does, you find it, it's fine.
Yeah, she has an education. All right, here we go.
Who said, ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country?
All right, we all know the answer. George Takei is the answer. But also John F. Kennedy asked that of the country. Now, will Andrea know that?
She's very young.
That's right.
No way.
I say no way also.
I don't think
she,
so.
She wouldn't know it.
I don't think so.
All right, let's find out.
George Bush?
All right, perfect.
Perfect. All right, so you got one right. You're on the board. Okay?
All right. Are we going to do 3 out of 5?
3 out of 5. All you need is 2 more right. Here we go. I'm keeping track of the score.
In which hemisphere is Antarctica?
In which hemisphere is Antarctica? Well, I'm not sure I know that.
It's a good one.
Yeah, because I don't... It's not, it's in the...
Isn't it like...
Well, if you split the world in half, it would be the southern hemisphere. Yeah. Yeah.
I don't think she knows that one either.
No way.
No, she wouldn't know it.
That's a tough one.
Hemisphere. Does that mean south or left? South Antarctica is south.
Wow.
She said south.
She did say south.
She didn't mean southern hemisphere, but she said south.
That's where it is.
Well, right. Gee, she did say it. I got to give her that one and take it away from you, Casey. Right, Robin?
Yeah.
Only fair.
You still have a chance.
Yeah, you're doing fine. Here we go.
What country is described as the Jewish homeland?
She got to know this, right?
She's got to know that.
I think so.
I say no. I say she doesn't know.
I say she'll say New Jersey.
I'm going to say she doesn't know the name Israel.
Oh, she's got to.
You say she does, Casey?
I think I'm going to go with yes.
Okay, let's find out.
Israel?
Yep, she knew that.
Yeah, she knew it. Know that.
All right, you've gotten 2 right. You need 1 more right, and you have 2 more questions. So you're okay. Here we go.
Who did President Bush defeat in the 2004 election?
Would she know the name? John Kerry. I'm going to say no way.
Yeah, she could have forgotten about
him.
She
should know that.
The rest of the country's forgotten. Why not us?
I'm going to say no way.
I don't think so either.
What will you say, Casey?
You're the important one. No way.
No way, okay.
Not sure. I'll leave it up.
I'm the lone vote.
What the crap is his name? He looks so dorky, too. Okay. I can't think of his name, but I know who he is. He's a dork.
He is a dork.
All right, you got another one right?
That's not
only
enough.
2 years ago.
By the way, that's 3 correct answers that you matched with
Andrea,
Miss Howard Stern, and you've won $500 cash and a copy of the movie Running Scared on DVD, the intense, fast-paced movie with sex and violence. Running Scared.
Congratulations.
Hi.
Hi, what is the parade tomorrow?
11:30. Good morning.
Oh, can I get the address for that parade, please?
No, we're not giving that out on the phone. We're doing it on the air.
Oh.
We'll give it right on the air. There you go. You can write it down for you right now. Good morning.
Morning, calling about the parade tomorrow.
Okay, we have...
That's at 11:30.
We also have now a haircut and a hot lather straight razor shave for $14, normally $20.
Good morning.
Good morning. Where's the parade?
Good morning.
I asked where...
We'll be taking a break here in just a minute.
Hello.
Who's in the parade?
It's all parade questions directed to the Kukakalpa. Hi.
I think Kuka Culpa.
What is Kuka Culpa?
Maybe that's Baba Booey, like their version.
Directed to the Kuka Culpa.
I don't understand the Tradio lingo. I got to find out what a Kuka Culpa is. If anybody knows, give me a call.
Wow.
Here, Tradio.
Here, Tradio Kuka Culpa.
Folks.
I love that line. All calls about the parade have to be directed to the Kuka Culpa.
I love that.
That's radio hell, Aaron.
That's right.
I don't understand something about this. Maybe Richard and Sal can clear it up. Why won't they answer any questions about the parade? Why is that taboo?
I don't know, but it sounds like they're trying to keep people tuned in, waiting for the address.
Or waste time because they're trying to get a lot of shit traded.
Well, nothing else is coming through but these calls.
Yeah, these guys know. They're way up on Tradio.
Yeah.
The reason why is because they're selling items.
Oh.
And that's the primary goal, to sell stuff.
I know, but like, why? They mentioned the parade.
Right.
And they gave out the time and they gave the location.
Right.
So you guys started calling. Like, even the first call, you say, I just wanted to know where it is.
Right.
And then they hang right up on you.
We've been calling them actually for 2 weeks, so they're kind of onto our voices.
They know us a little bit, yeah.
Oh, so they're hanging up right away when they recognize the sound of your voice.
Yeah. Right, right, right.
But so they also have a ton of stuff they want to sell, so they want to get right to that.
Oh. Yeah. The parade thing is
secondary.
It's not a tune-in factor.
Yeah. Superfluous.
Right. That's why, if you notice, when Richard and I call in, the guy jumps right into an item for sale. He sells a certificate to a barbershop.
What is a Kuka Culpa?
We don't know.
I think it's the group that's putting on the parade.
Oh, I think it's a person like Baba
Booey. Kuka Culpa?
Please call Baba Booey. Baba Booey.
Yeah, that's right. The guy immediately said, we got a hot lather shave.
Right, right.
He's got that all.
You should have called him.
You should have been on that, Artie. You love those.
I do like those.
I was thinking of you. Hey, I got to go back to the Kuka Culpa.
What a bargain.
I love this.
Who's in the parade?
The Kuka Culpa.
Who's in the parade?
All parade questions directed to the Kuka Culpa.
Kuka Culpa.
Hi.
Who's in the parade?
Hello?
Hi,
Loretta? Do you ever have too much time on your hands like these guys? Mm-hmm. They might want to.
Loretta sounds like a party.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Loretta sounds like she's got plenty of time.
She's like, you know, we run a serious Tradio.
Consider getting something better to do. Hello?
How long is the parade tomorrow?
Hello?
Who's playing in the parade?
Okay, you know what? This is the Super Saver Hotline. We sell things here. If you have any other questions, we're not going to answer them for you right now. Good morning.
What kind of parade is?
If these lovely callers keep wanting to know about the parade, they can call the Kuka Culpa. We'll be happy to answer any questions regarding the parade. Just so you can.
I think the Kuka Culpa is like the Wizard of Oz.
No, it's something, but everything I pull up on Kuka Culpa,
I know, it's like Spanish.
Is in Spanish.
Si. I mean, Jess.
It's something from Brazil.
Kuka Culpa.
With the Kuka Culpa.
How do you spell Kuka Culpa?
Kuka Culpa.
How do you spell that?
C-U-C-A-C-U-L-P-A.
How'd you figure that out?
I didn't. That's what came up when I jumbled up some words and put it into the search engine.
What did you originally spell?
Let me see. What did I spell?
Kuka Culpa.
I actually spelled it right. Kuka Culpa.
Jeez, you're out of control.
Get going with the show, because I know you've got a lot to sell today.
Thank you. There you go, boys. Hi.
Good morning, Marianne. How you doing? Enough of this parade now.
Hello?
What's the parade theme tomorrow?
Hello?
The parade?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Hi.
We have today, we have a haircut.
Ghim đã bán thì đã bán rồi, mọi người không cần phải liên hệ nhiều. Còn nếu bên em chưa ghim thì ở phần mô tả thì chứng tỏ là chưa bán. Còn xe nào đã bán thì bên em đã ghim. Đấy. Mọi người liên hệ sớm, còn em ghim đã bán thì là không còn xe ở đâu. Xe rất là đẹp, màu đỏ, rất là đồng bóng. 170 triệu mọi người nhé. Và ai chốt thì phải liên hệ sớm với em. Và xin chào tất cả mọi người nhé. Xe em chuyên các dòng xe nổi nhé. Xin chào tất cả mọi người.